Welcome back to the home of table tennis. This is WTT Champions Xinjiang 2023 presented by ICBC. And as the city starts to glow, the one place, the arena where it is all going down, is just shining so bright inside. This is the Infinity Arena and the main table, the TV table, that will serve the greatest players on the planet. We are down to the quarterfinal stage of action. Players battling for a chance to fight tomorrow. What do we have coming up in this session? Chun Meng, Big Dream, Da Meng, the Olympic champion, versus Hina Hayata of Japan. A battle that, well, the internet has weighed in on, and we'll tell you about that in a bit. World number one, Fan Zhendong versus Lin Shidong, a battle of generations with the up-and-coming Padawan, Sun Ying Xia. World number one versus Mima Ito, leading lady for Japan. And in the end, Ruin Filus, the top chopper in the world, versus the silent assassin, Lin Wenru of the Chinese Taipei team. But now it is the women's singles quarterfinal.
首先让我们有请世界排名第九位来自日本的早田希娜。
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the world number 9 from Japan, Hina Hayata.
现在让我们一起欢呼庆祝世界排名第四位来自中国的陈梦。
Let's welcome the world number 4 from China, Chen.
So here she comes, the Olympic champion. Chun Meng has been on top of the world for some time, but Sun Ying Xia passed her by, and recently she dropped to world rank number 4. Quite unusual to see, but with all the expiration of points, the world number 4 has played 4 times against Hina Hayata, and guess how many she's won? No need to guess, it's an open book test. 4 out of 4 attempts against Hina Hayata. So the world rank number 4 versus the world rank number 9. Versus left-handers, 83%. I think her career's got to be about 86%. So, will be interesting to see Hina Hayata here with coach Daisuke Ishida, who's been around the world and working with Hina for quite some time. A little back support there. Well, for a best of 5 games, it'll be fast and furious. That means first player to win 3 games wins the match. Ma Lin in the corner for Chun Meng. Vipin Mera, our umpire for the match, keeps his eyes on everything necessary. And now the players will come together for a toss of the coin that will determine the fate of who serves and where the players stand. Nervous? Well, stay here.
For the toss, white and black. White is gold. You won the toss. You will serve. See?
So Chun Meng chooses to serve after winning the toss. They'll check each other's equipment just to be clear on what it is that is being played with on the other side. Sometimes the subtlest of changes, whether it's a new sheet of rubber, a different thickness of the sponge underneath, a new blade, anything of the sort, players want to be as informed as possible as what's to come. I'm your commentator, Adam Bobro, joining me in the commentary booth, back from a bit of action, Fraser Riley. Fraser, this one's looking good.
Hello, my brother, using different rubbers. It certainly is. I cannot wait to see how Hayata here can test the Olympic champion.
I like what you said there, Jun Ji-hee. 3-0 there. Strong fight. She had beaten Chun Meng before, but Masumi Ishikawa as well, not able to put a dent in the heart of Big Meng. Hey, we got some bunny ears there. Happy belated Easter to those of you that enjoy. Hina Hayata, 22 years old, world rank number 9, 9 years a pro. That means she went pro at 13 years old, and she's taken 9 events. So, dangerous service game, 3-0 through Fu Yu, 3-0 through Nina Mittelham, and now the biggest test yet. What do you expect to see, Fraser?
Well, I expect to see one of these two lose again for the first time this event. And, I mean, obviously, Chun Meng favorite, but we know Hayata is probably top 2 best servers in the game.
Yeah, I think alongside her teammate Mima Ito, just 2 of the trickiest servers. She has so much variety in her service game, is very whippy, is the taller of the two players. So, you saw what they're playing with, what they're playing for, the equipment, the prize money, $800,000, and here's what the fans think. Well, now, Interesting. 4-0, Chun Meng has never lost, but the fans believe that 52% likelihood Hina Hayata will win this. There is a chance that fans around the world are disproportionately represented by Japanese fans. Wishful thinking can be a powerful thing for sure. That said, I wouldn't put it past Hina Hayata. So go to worldtabletennis.com, whether you want to change that statistic or that fan vote, either direction. You think Chun Meng deserves a little bit more faith from the crowd, a little bit more belief? Do you think Hina Hayata needs even more support? Go to worldtabletennis.com or the WTT app and check out the match center to cast your vote.
Jinping to serve.
Okay, here we go. It's a best of five. It'll be Chun Meng to start it off with the serves. Love all. Fired up right out of the gates. Every point is going to be crucial for Hina Hayata to live up to the fans' expectations.
We've seen Japanese players overthrow big Chinese ones on their come up, but can that last for Hayata?
Oh, double happiness once again after the work that Hina Hayata put in. She got oohs and ahs out of the crowd after hitting the short side of the table on the run. Just relentless attacks.
The versatility, amazing. Chun Meng to read that Hayata forehand down the line. Impressive, despite the fortune that she got.
So a tough way to end for Hina Hayata, but an outstanding second point for the spectators. Short side of the table, beautiful parallel backhand.
I love those shots where you opt for the placement over the power. Went against the momentum of Chun Meng, who guessed too soon.
Nice surprise factor here from Hina Chan. Good pressure and placement. Chun Meng getting Hina Hayata to pull the forehand out of the middle.
Let do all.
I try to think to myself, on a day like today, what would it take for Hina Hayata to pull this off, to win three games before Chun Meng does?
Three, two.
I don't know, I imagine you've thought the same. What are your thoughts about that?
Hayata doesn't want to be too route one. Doesn't want to play too powerfully, too regularly. I think spin variation is going to be huge here. She can constantly change the direction and trajectory of her balls. She stands a chance.
Chun Meng quick on the step to get in and take advantage. Coach Ishida watching from the corner, recognizing that it's well played on the other side. That ball doesn't seem to be very long. Could have come down for a second bounce at baseline, but Chun Meng stealing the opportunity, recognizing, taking her chances.
Three, four.
I mean, it's quite obvious in every match that it's so important, but seems even more important against the looming Chinese threat, serve-receive. We know Hayata is very good at that.
I like the way she followed her serve there. Had that ball come down, she was quickly in position for the forehand attack.
Ooh, stamping a foot on the serve.
Fairly common, as we see in table tennis, just to mask the sound of the contact, as that contact, the sound that's created, is such a big indicator as to how much spin is on the ball.
I like it. Trying everything.
Let for all.
As a chun.
Yeah, fairly common out here.
Five, four.
So clean with that opening backhand, picks the forehand corner. Hina Hayata to go for. How fluid is that? The way she drops the racket and let it hang.
It's not an easy shot. And it wasn't in a comfortable backhand zone either. It was kind of middle.
4-6.
Speaking of middle, a half-long serve here right between coming off. But Hina Hayata, I was going to say between coming off and being forced to play the push. Hina Hayata looking for that attack. Some quick points there from Chun Meng to step out in front. Parallel to your favorite.
Straight out of the table tennis textbook. Done that a couple of times now, Hayata. Chun Meng's going to want to try and keep that receive loose. I think it was actually a good receive from Chun. Good intention with the long, fast push.
Nice inside out forehand, bread and butter. We see a lot of left-handed players willing to step around the corner. Although in the women's game, it's just too fast close to the table. Look how tight that serve is, barely over the net. And the follow-up shot right back to where it came from, but even wider. The jewelry there, the table tennis jewelry. Personalized for Chun Meng.
6-0.
He's got it on her neck as well. Da Meng, Big Dream, they call her in China.
Flat 6-0.
Just a little reminder, there's no limit to how many let serves you can serve. Right into that pocket, Chun Meng drilling away with placement.
They're both getting each other with that kind of side spinny, top spinny serve into each other's forehand. Noticed. Let's see if they can both improve in that receive.
Very patient play as Chun Meng waits to see where the body weight goes, where the best option is. I mean, it was so casual. She just had the racket up high and saw the backhand corner was a little opening and pounced forward.
He's at the edge of the table there. Hayata worried probably about playing on the parallel straight away.
7-8. Beautiful leaping backhand. We saw a lot of that from Chun Xing Tong earlier today.
We did. How many third ball attack kills have we seen? So many.
Now this is the goal. Players looking to end the point as quickly as possible, but usually it takes several patterns and combinations before it can be ended, depending on the receive game off quite often. Strong receive here, but Hayata with the racket high, ready for a quick counter, ties it up.
Big old point that one, because now at 8-all, it's anyone's. Imagine 2 points down facing two serves of the Olympic champion. Not an ideal situation.
Quality push. Pretty gutsy, really. I mean, after the backhand that we saw from Chun Meng before, for Hina Hayata to pick that fight really had to be specific in her spin.
It was almost silent, the receive. She cut under it that much. The contact was so fine. Amazing receive there from Hina Hayata.
I couldn't believe she bent her body that far to play the forehand from the elbow. Hina Hayata then makes the shot and recovers. Watch the body movement on this one. Wow. The perfect placement, Chun Meng behind the momentum.
Some amazing anatomical contortion. Show that to your mates and try and convince them table tennis is a sport. Because there's a lot of people out there that don't think it is, but...
Oh, man, good times. 9 points apiece here. And a serve to set up game point. For Hina Hayata, a second serve now. Interesting. Side top again.
A smile after it as well.
I think this is the positive reinforcement of the Japanese women's team. Ooh, slows it down and spins on the chase, tactically wise, instead of going for the kill. And with Miyu Kihara and the team video analysis and physio, everyone is watching closely as Hina Hayata takes the first game against a player who suffered some losses at the hands of non-Chinese players recently. Internet so far, predictions are right, 52%. It's about the points she took here as well. 11 of 20 points played. Hina Hayata, 1-0. Here's a look at who's left of the top seeds. Well, we got six of them left. Wang Manyu had been eliminated by the sixth seed here. Chun Xingtong, you see in blue. Han Ying, taken out earlier by Xin Yubin. Although Sha Sha will be playing Mima Ito, so the world number one Sun Ying Sha has filled the stadium here, but Chun Meng, the number four spot right now versus the number seven. What about the men? Wow, only two left standing. Two. My goodness, interesting. And the Chinese nicknames, Little Fatty and Big Fatty, those are the two ones left. So a variety of sizes in our fattiness, royal fattiness, in Fan Zhendong, the world number one, and Liang Jingquan. And we also have Little Fatty, Xiao Xiao Pong, Lin Shidong. He'll be battling against the world number one, Fan Zhendong, later on in this session.
Second game, Hina Hayata to serve. Lower.
So a lot of pressure still. We've seen upsets in the first game before the stronger of the two players turn things around. Checking out her opponent, a little evaluation before she chooses the serve. It's Hina Hayata in the lead. That run, forehand love. Is so whippy.
Yeah, that's the word I was about to use.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's just a blur, isn't it?
Hey, one, two, three, whippy.
Spud me.
I thought you were going to say whippy.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Next time.
Yeah. Like we're finishing each other's
sentences.
Sandwiches. Oh. Shoot, forget it.
One all.
It's a good point here on the receive. Chun Meng gets the serves back. I'll be curious to see, what do you think Chun Meng might change to lay some authority down?
That's a good question. Let me have a think for a second.
Sure. Time. No, take your time.
One, two.
Should have said it before she served, because I was about to say change the serve there.
Thought you were going to say make Chun Meng look down at her racket after missing a shot.
No.
No, that's not the first time we've seen this. So in terms of momentum here, Hina Hayata, six of the last 8 points. Some serious momentum. Ooh.
Three.
Tongue
one.
Out from Chun Meng. Don't see that too often.
Well, well, well. With two serves now, Hayata will be looking to at least keep a two-point cushion. She's accustomed to the Chun Meng cross-table serve, the pendulum serve. Chun trying to change it there.
Lead, three, one.
That is a good point. She was trying to change it up. A little bottle challenge. We see that for righties versus lefty and vice versa.
Right, please.
Seems that there's a flash in the crowd. The fans just being responsible, taking care of the players. Flash photography, I think. Our head umpire, has his back to that part of the crowd. Must not have seen the light in the crowd. Crowd took care of it. Thank you, crowd. Xinxiang making it exceptionally comfortable for the players. They are the sheriffs here, the fans. Surprise and
four,
roaring
one.
This parallel backhand, lovely.
Not showing where she's going and now showing the orange glowing Hina Hayata.
She is orange glowing in a lot of ways. You can see it right after that ripping backhand. A lot of effort to get those first two back. It's interesting, that camera angle gives us a variety of sort of understandings of what it's like, a new perspective. But who would have possibly predicted that Hina would be tested to go that wide in both directions? The backhand actually seemed more reasonable to reach than the two forehands before.
Right. Change of placement, showing right there how effective it can be.
So Chun Meng that two-point cushion that Hina Hayata wanted, split the last 2 points. Three, four. Little acknowledgement for the fortune, the top of the net there to slow the ball down and bring it in low and awkward for Hina Hayata.
That was an absolutely loaded topspin.
Heavy underspin, fast serve, and the short push attempted. Hina Hayata still looking for some answers out here, but some quick points now. Chun Meng dead even.
It's tough, isn't it, to get that balance, because even though you're in the match, you don't want to get too drawn into it. Otherwise, you may step in too soon. Again, it's that fine line of reacting too early and too late.
Five, four.
Whoa. Coach Ishida, sounding like Ma Lin over there in the corner. Some serious vocalization quickly for Hina Hayata. That is such a difficult shot. The finger breaker, the way she ever so carefully brushes up the back of the ball and still manages to keep it a spinny, effective shot. Welcome to the next level.
Five, six.
I would have thought it was loaded with underspin, and it seemed that Chun Meng thought the same as she lifts to loop.
Sometimes when the bat makes contact with the table when you go for a push, it can have that effect.
Right, exactly. As you saw in the replay, the contact, there wasn't so much racket speed brushing the ball, but the table hit contact was a big sort of misleading factor. Not intentional, just happened that way. Ooh.
7-5.
Screaming like we haven't heard before from Hina Hayata. If she can get through this game victoriously, remember, two players, both from Romania in recent history, have beaten Chun Meng, Elisabetta Samara and Bernadette Such. Hina Hayata, one of the top two non-Chinese players in the world, and Japan, well, way closer to Team China than anyone in the world. Edge of the table. I think she had a few in the bank, though, in terms of some TTKs and table tennis karma.
Indeed. Indeed. I mean, you can't imagine the amount of pressure it takes to be a Chinese table tennis player. You're not just fighting for the present, you're fighting for the future. And Chun Meng up against a big foreign threat here. If she wants to play the Olympics,
six matches like that.
And I mean, we've seen, even in the women's game recently, Lucia Wen, the world champion, not selected for the Olympic Games. It goes to show there's not much sentimentality in the Chinese selection process.
It's business. It is making sure that you secure the golds without losing to Mima Ito. Chun Meng is a very strong case, but Lucia Wen's record against Mima Ito, not the same. And Hina Hayata with a three-point lead here, getting deep into this game. Six serving nine, Chun Meng, you could argue, really could use this point right now.
Nine, seven.
The backhand, whatever the acknowledgement was for, she secures the point. Zhang Ruwei there, the only one with the bare face. So low, that backhand, as it crosses the net just barely above.
Nine, eight.
Interesting, I'm looking over to the coach's corner here.
He looks on the brink of calling the timeout, but he's not, is he?
Here it is.
Oh.
Oh, man. It's the edge of your seat moment. Had 9-6, 2 points in a row for Chun Meng, who's won every encounter they've had out of four before this. So a little reminder of what's to come. Fan Zhendong in the practice hall, the world number one. Guess who his practice partner is? I'll give you a hint. His name is on screen and it's not Fan Zhendong. It's Lin Shidong. Xiao Xiaopeng, the 17-year-old little fatty. Might even say tiny fatty if you wanted to, but he's explosive. It's incredible to watch him play. So we'll see how that freshness and fearlessness comes up against the world number one and all of his experience.
I'll tell you what, Adam.
Yeah.
All these who I imagine to be Japanese fans that have voted on WTT's match center look like absolute insightful geniuses right now, don't they?
So far, yes, but it is a crucial point. Interesting. For some reason, I forgot that it was 9-7. It felt like it had already become 9-8 in my head. Maybe it was just because of all that waiting for the timeout before the point was played.
9-8, 9-7.
Nagashimasu, she says. Shall we play? Some respect for the opponent, the officials, and her coach. This is Japanese tradition, you will see. Little bows and the onegaishimasu. Back from the timeout. There it is, 9-8 on screen. 1 point lead for Hina Hayata. Tighter
eight,
serve
ten.
And surprise deception there on the contact. Quite impressive.
Chun Meng was expecting it to come into the forehand side, but it came actually right in the dead center of the table because the first bounce was less wide than what Chun Meng thought. Very clever, composed serving.
So now we've got two game points. The player who's cashed in her timeout, I guess it will be cashed in if she can cross the finish line here in game two. Long push, just missing the back edge. Chun Meng survives and has one more serve to deuce it up. Never noticed that pinky nail of Ma Lin.
Didn't catch it.
Oh, you'll catch it soon. If you, it'll catch you. Look like a cleaning device. Probably is. 9 serving 10. Outstanding play. Opening it up to the wide forehand. Chun Meng, it takes many shots in this rally. Nice attempted change of pace out there from Hina Hayata. But adjusting and adapting, this is what the most experienced woman on the Chinese team right now can do under pressure.
Hayata has to think with the kind of clarity here that she did in the first game if she wants to get the second one in the bag.
Parallel backhand.
11.
Again, a very whippy backhand. I feel like it's partially this old service delivery where Hina Hayata would let the arm dangle under the table like an elephant trunk. She just has, it seems like she has so many joints in those long arms. Game point, back to Hina Hayata. Third game point saved by Chun Meng. We've talked about bravery, and I feel like sometimes playing it soft in a tense moment, or just trusting that you can spin the ball enough to deter the opponent's attack, that also takes bravery, but it takes a very clear mind beforehand.
Wow, change of toss height from Hayata, placement and spin, but Chun Meng adapts.
I was a little surprised just because of the netball before. Set it up, Chun Meng with the backhand. But I mean, she's been really taking this game in the business end here. 6 of the last 8 points have worked out to favor Chun Meng. And it's game point for the Olympic champion. That's always gonna be tough. Hina Hayata pounds that ball down the line, the forehand.
Wow, Adam, this is amazing, isn't it?
Why do you say that?
For me, I mean, the amount of sort of 6 of the last 8 point stats we've seen here shows that if your concentration lapses for a split second, you're going to get punished, and it shows the strength and depth of this entire event.
Right from the start, the round of 32. A woman who was eliminated recently, Wang Manyu, was tested by Dina Meshref of Egypt. And it just keeps getting tougher and tougher as they go.
13-12.
Yet another game point for Chun Meng.
From one Olympic champion to the other, Marlin. Wow.
Deep in thought here, a serve to make it count. Alternating serves now only. And the heavy serve right there at the baseline. Hina Hayata takes her chances bravely, but overwhelmed by spin and protected well. Chun Meng secures the game, saving multiple game points. Look how close to the baseline that is. She was down 8-10, Chun Meng, and it didn't stop her. She just toughened up 14-12. They both scored 23 points so far. So dead even. Conversation continues. This one right here will be focused. Big dreams, making dreams reality. The table, the purple lines on this double fish volant king.
Third game, Jane makes the serve. Love all.
So Hina Hayata with her head on straight here after a very tough fought game number two. Had her chances, no doubt. But you could argue that that timeout was never cashed in. No timeouts left for Hina Hayata. One game apiece.
Let love all. Love one.
Again, there's that sort of quickly stopping at the table push that's been a little bit tougher to read on the other side.
Yep, you can't heavy spin a float ball unless your contact is basically perfect. Not a lot of room to maneuver there as well. Hayata pushing into the middle quite regularly.
2-love.
Speaking of middle, a nice backhand to backhand exchange in Hayata finding an uncomfortable place.
I feel like there'd be extra relief in Hayata if she manages to win this game three, especially after having two game points. She can't think about that though. It's that reset button that players just have to press.
2-1.
Seemed like the edge of the racket there, Chun Meng. Either way, taking the point. Still a 1-point lead for Hina Hayata. From behind the table, even falling back for a moment, Chun Meng still able to impose a threat.
Block of Hayata just went into the net. Quite low, actually. That can be the effect sometimes of the Chinese rubber. Different kind of contact feeling to that of a European rubber.
It's not the first time we've seen this. Hina Hayata with an outstanding first shot, but she has to lean way into the table, get her weight forward, and Chun Meng exploits that by playing it right back to the baseline. That's really outstanding play from Chun Meng in a wide place. I think Hina Hayata stretched her quite deep to the forehand at the angle. And still that much pressure. Feet weren't even on the ground when she played it.
Great shot selection from Chun Meng, wasn't it, to play a slower, loopier ball.
with receives like this, it is going to be a very tough road for Hina Hayata. Now, we talk about bottle challenge serves. You know, a lefty serving long to the backhand pendulum into the right-handed backhand side.
Five,
not here, half long, just a little bit change. It appeared to be a float serve, something where she contacted it a little bit more square instead of brushing for heavy underspin.
Taking a lot of time to think about this serve, Chen Meng. Ritualistic. There it is, for the first time I think we've seen that.
Little strawberry side spin. I feel like that'd be a cute sort of figurine to sell. Strawberry side spin.
Yeah.
Or dessert.
Yeah.
A lot of good marketing opportunities here for table tennis establishments. Five serving four. Hina Hayata coming back in with a bit of creativity. Oh, the banana split. Speaking of which, under and side spin, the same side spin as the banana flick. Again, not many doing that shot. Mima Ito, probably the only other one in the game that does that shot.
Five,
beautiful
six.
Contact again on the parallel. This is the beauty of spin. I mean, even though the ball was changed from celluloid to plastic, it's still such a huge factor.
Reminds me of coming through the airport. If you're watching right now and you get stopped in China for table tennis balls, just let them know that for the last many years now, the ball's been made of plastic. There is no celluloid.
I'm sure they understand.
All.
They did. That was the question.
Oh.
6 points apiece. I think that was probably the most useful time it would ever be, sort of to have that knowledge in your pocket.
Yeah.
Coming through airport security with like 40 table tennis balls. Just being like, no, not anymore. These are all plastic. For health and safety of the workers in the factory and those traveling, less flammable the balls.
Seven, six.
So quick to change it up and go down the line. Chen Meng really took the footing out from Hina Hayata's side.
Very flammable there. Nice control, just gauged it, didn't go for a huge shot. And didn't close the racket too much either. It was a little bit of side spin.
Seven all.
As opposed to the side of the racket or the edge.
Indeed.
Which we saw used there, unintentionally. Here's something you have to remember. These players keep the racket so closed when they play. It's not like they're just swinging forward with an open face of the racket. The angle, it's amazing that they don't hit the edge of the racket considerably more frequently. 7 points apiece.
8-7.
Fired up as can be, this tight serve. Chen Meng not able to brush up and grip to get it over the net.
Contacting it. As close to the edge as you can get. Look at that.
Six of the last 8 points to Japan's Hina Hayata.
You could do the same service motion, but if the ball hits the center of the bat, it'll create less spin.
Compared to hitting the end of the racket, of course.
Yeah.
It is an interesting point. This is something the servers at this level have so many different ways to keep their serve unpredictable. Think about that. Where they hit the ball on the racket, closer to the hand or towards the end of the racket, just to generate different amounts of spin. So much to watch at this level. Good setup from Chen Meng, and she follows down the middle of the table to go up by one.
The rallies are shortening, and that could be a result of this tight situation here.
Talk about bold receives I mean, this was like the table had no edge, no corner. If you were playing on a perfectly smooth, round table, you still might be hesitant just to bruise your finger. Look at Coach Ishida.
Wow, he's doing the YMCA dance. He is absolutely buzzing.
The first quarter of it.
Yeah.
we turn back and he's actually doing the M, the C, and the A right now.
I'll tip Ayata wins this game. He might see the M.
Let's see.
Or the W if you turn it upside down. I don't know how you do that.
Coach Ishida's in a headstand. Tight serve sets up game point on his feet. 1 point away from a 2-1 lead. She had 10-8 last game, and it wasn't enough. Japanese camp physio strength training out there. Chun Meng just straightening up. Getting everything ready to send this to deuce. But it's Hina Hayata who shuts down game number three victoriously. A 2-1 lead. The underdog, the world number 9 versus the Olympic champion. And the fans, with all their votes, so far seem to have willed Hina Hayata through. Of course, this is on Hina Hayata and her team, but the fans will be happy as they watch. But here in Xinjiang, China, the majority of the crowd will be on the edge of their seat rooting on Chun Meng. Check out Hina Chan now.
Fourth game, Hina Hayata to serve.
Chun Meng still Love finishing whatever she's chewing on to get some energy. Rumor has it it's banana. There are a lot of different fruits that look exactly like bananas in their shape and color. Okay, maybe not. Probably a banana. Here we go. Hina Hayata, 2-1. Starts off with the serves. Oh, still goes for it. I can't believe she didn't. I mean, we would have expected a fishing shot or a lob or something. We saw Lin Shidong pull one off like this the other day that was out of this world. But footwork here and reach from Hina Hayata. Really trying to keep that pressure on. I love that flailing backhand with that big after motion from Chun Meng to redirect. Countered from behind the table. Hayata looking strong.
This is why she's so effective as well in mixed doubles. Her ability to play balls like that. Silver medalist in the World Championships alongside Tomokazu Harumoto.
Fast long serve. Hayata seems up to the task. Makes her first two shots in this rally, but Chun Meng just one faster. This is the thing, in terms of taking advantage of having your serve, if you're going to serve fast and long, you're already mentally very prepared for a quick rally. Oh, heavy side spin on that chop block from Hayata.
Yeah, brilliant. In an uncomfortable position. I mean, you'd still expect Chun Meng to make it, hence the gasp from the crowd. Still a good feeling. We'd love to see it, don't we, Adam?
Yeah, it's always exciting to see a bit of side spin introduced to the game. Reactionary sort of last resort from Hayata, but it paid off. The quality and the placement on this one is going to make it very tough for Hina Hayata to come back with the counter.
Look at that flick. That is poetry in motion. Can be hard to get over quite a loopy shot.
Yeah, you could tell that Hina Hayata was making sure she stayed at the baseline of the table, taking the ball early, taking her chances.
4-2.
Top of the net, but it stays on Hayata's side. Chun Meng is going to be quite determined to win every point so that she can not only win game four, but in the decider take this match. Look at the stadium here from almost what appears to be the opposite side of where we're sitting. Lead service.
4-2.
Chun Meng with the recovery off the net ball like it never even happened.
I don't know what Martin Lin told him. My Chinese is as good as my Japanese, aka non-existent, but looks like Chun Meng is playing quite a lot of balls into the middle to get a weaker ball from Hayata and then going either side.
Three, five.
Nice flick here, some pressure from inside the table, a much needed point here, step in the right direction for a player who barely came through the first and the third game and almost the second, but that was Chun Meng, 14-12.
Three, six.
Can you feel it in the air? It feels like, I don't know, this goes to a fifth. Percentage-wise, you'd have to back Chun Meng if you were a betting man. She has won 95% of her matches against non-Chinese opponents.
Not the first time we've seen Hina Hayata just spin the ball back, arc it baseline, change the rhythm, and cause some trouble on the other side. Now remember, you might know this from Ask a Pro Anything, but Hina Hayata would write Onaka on the inside of her wrist, which my Japanese is limited, but that means stomach. That was her way of keeping her stomach in and head down and forward, keeping her weight forward.
Wow. That's a cool
six,
little thought there, Adam.
Four.
Thanks.
Never heard a player do that before. Write a literal reminder on your own body.
Ariel Shing for USA used to write, let go.
Oh, wow.
Six,
and Chun
Tzu
has a tattoo on her ankle that says brave.
Game on. Mm.
So there you go. And a timeout here. 2 points in a row. Fans watching from all over the world. Japanese, Korean, Chinese, German. This is a big match to watch right now. Perfect placement there from Hina Hayata near the back of the table. We've seen Chun Meng make shots quite similar before. She sort of replays this in her head.
This would kind of feel like the tip of the iceberg for Chung after losing already to two Romanians recently.
Right. Little reminder, we've had some big events in recent history, but we've got some really big ones coming up. We've got the WTT Champions Macau next week, the 17th through the 23rd. A bunch of your favorite players from here will be going there. And then the WTT Star Contender in Bangkok from the 23rd through the 29th, back in Thailand. And then in Durban, South Africa, May 20th through the 28th, it is the World Championships. The world has been waiting to see who will take the biggest event of the year, the title that has been celebrated for a good portion of a century.
Six, five.
So still 1 point in front, Chun Meng out of her timeout. Remember, this is a must-win game for Chun Meng.
Five,
not a bad push
seven.
Right at the baseline. Gave herself a chance for a predictable counter, but Chun Meng keeps it quality and into the middle.
It kind of feels like a win-win hitting into the middle. Because not only is it the crossover section of your opponent, but it's kind of safer than going for a wider angle.
I guess it depends where you're hitting from. From the middle of the table, corners are going to be a little bit more forgiving.
Yeah, good point, good point.
Thanks.
Well, man.
Every once in a while. Five serving seven here. Perfectly placed into the middle again. We've talked about it when the women's game, we see a lot more speed play to the middle. But in general, anytime you can get someone, I mean, it's perfectly placed on that elbow. Those last few shots, we saw Hina Hayata just trying to maneuver to really get a comfortable ball back, but it couldn't happen. Well, now, I thought Chun Meng's shot was pretty amazing, and Hina Hayata didn't seem to think the same.
That was incredible.
As low as can be on the parallel, Hina Hayata with a closed racket fans out and just drills it back low to the net on the parallel for the win.
When you know you're so good at the countertop spin game, that half long serve can be a good tactic.
Bottle challenge and corner to corner. Hayata catches the edge of the racket. It's Chun Meng really directing traffic in that point. The amount of time between shots, it's just amazing that she can quickly get ready and redirect. 3 points in front now for Chun Meng. So sparkly. Oh, back edge of the table. They've got to be about even now in terms of fortune, but it's 4 game points for Chun Meng. And that's the closest thing to frustration I've seen from Hina Hayata in as long as I can recall. Just the body language in an outstanding rally. Hina Hayata, very close. And Chun Meng skates on through 11-6 to take game number 4. So, you know what to do. Grab those snacks and healthy beverages and tell your friends if they're not already watching. They need to be, because coming right up, the decider, game number 5. It is the final game to determine who will move on to the semifinals. World number 4 Olympic champion Chun Meng, or the second lady for the Japanese team, Hina Hayata, world number 9. Momentum heavily favoring the player who called the timeout most recently, Chun Meng. Hot pot, but in times like this, wouldn't be so convenient, really.
Imagine Marlin just there with a portable stove.
Yeah.
First and final game, Jing Ming to serve. Love all.
Stretching out the back, the whole body trying to stay limber and loose, and keeping the blood flowing, looking like the same on the other side. Again, potassium is the arch nemesis of cramps.
One love.
This match right now is just getting so gritty. They are fighting so hard for control of space behind the table.
In China, Adam, as you well know, is the arch nemesis of Japan. The reasons that we see here. Hayata's taken 2 games off Chun Meng before, but as that head-to-head and the tail of the table showed, every time into Chun Meng.
It's tough when you've come so far to not be able to close the door to finish the job. Wow. Back down into her own side of the table. and 7 of the last 8 points to Chun Meng. The most one-sided game after that timeout was called in game 4 was game 4 itself.
1-2.
Much needed point here, a little bit of confidence in the tank.
A massive point. And look how much shorter these rallies are now. Looking to win it as soon as possible, but having plan B, C, D, E, F, and G if it doesn't go 100%
stop
to plan.
Clear China. Please don't delay the match. 1-2.
That's a pretty astute observation. I was gonna say impressive. Either way, the fact that he recognized the receiver was stalling.
You don't usually see
that. You see servers told to serve and play, but sometimes they're just waiting for their opponent to come to the table.
I wasn't so sure on the rule, but now it makes sense why Yuan Lachin got the red card against Alexis LeBrun.
Right. No stalling. So quick 2 points here. Hina Hayata turning things around well. I'm curious if people have been voting online, worldtabletennis.com, to see how things have changed now that we're here after all that momentum shift into Chun Meng's favor.
3-2.
Pin in that middle like a pinata against Hayata.
Heard the word pinata, had a feeling we might end up there.
maybe I should add a bit of subtleness to my comedy then, Adam.
No, it's good. I like it. Well, now, to get that low, Hayata, some fancy footwork to create space there for the forehand. Subtle applause here. Some guarded optimism. That lean and then the punch as soon as she gets back.
One of the most impressive shots, isn't it, when a player sweeps their leg to make room.
It's impressive when they come back to play the follow-up shot. I mean, it's impressive, yes. But getting back from after just taking yourself out of position for the shot before. Quality at the back of the table. Chun Meng has been quite consistent in that receive game.
Hayata there. Going for the half long serve again, but it's a centimeter too long. That can be costly. Against Chun Meng especially.
Surprise, surprise, it's fast for the backhand. Chun Meng doing an excellent job of recapturing the space near the table. From that camera angle, you could really see her moving back in. Gotta love that. I mean, it's just so efficient. Playing a stroke with quality, but also moving back into the table.
5-3.
I mean, only the best in the world can do this consistently under pressure against someone who's putting on so much pressure. So they have switched sides of the table now. As one player has reached 5 points, and that player is Chun Meng, who has the serves.
Six, three.
A bit of strawberry side spin here, but enough height on the ball for Chun Meng. It's not easy. Has to really jump, but keeps the sort of looseness and fluidity there that she needs for the racket speed to get over that ball. Oh, the roar, the scream. You just have to love the passion. Hina Hayata fighting her way back, still down by 2. Soft flick. Those ripping backhands.
Beautiful. Taking them quite early. Earlier than she'd take a spin up.
I feel like she's using the length that she has in the limbs to catch them out in front. Send the ball back before it's traveled so far.
5-6.
Determination and clarity of thought there. Brilliant.
No timeouts left. Chun Meng had one. She'd use it now. Yeah, we haven't seen a shot quite like that in some time. Very unusual inside the table to commit in that way, leaving open the backhand corner. Top edge of the racket. It's heavy spin from Chun Meng to earn the point in a much needed moment, as close to level as can be before that happened.
So every point is such a battle. Marlin, animated as a coach, as he was as a player.
You might even argue more.
I love the selflessness of the Chinese national team coaches. They wouldn't mind if their player achieves more than them.
They would actually probably love it.
7-6.
I mean, you can't change the past once you've retired, right? Just like parents. I think they want the best for their kids, and there's this similarity here with these coaches and their players. They've spent such a significant portion of the players' lives together. I mean, Darko Jorgic and his coach since the time he was like 5. Chun Meng 1 point up, second serve. Side of the table, that's Ayata's point. She says, let's look at a replay. For me, that's the right call. You could hear just the sound. There was nothing but side on this. And watch the trajectory. That's complete side. No. Chun Meng obviously thought she caught something, but
I can see why in the heat of the moment you would try to contest just in case, but I mean...
Right. Yeah, it was an honest mistake, but we saw pretty clearly what happened. So the call was made correctly. The best umpires in the world here. Sound alone, though. I mean, we know what the sound of the side of a table sounds like. That metal skirt. Referring to the table, of course. Beautiful point. And Chun Meng with a quick recovery. Man, you can't even imagine how much thought is running through that brain after this point. The speed on that forehand from Hayata. Chun Meng has worked her whole life to be able to return shots like that in moments like these. Still, this match is not over. 7-8 in the decider. Rushing backhand, side spin in a moment like that. How do you feel?
The final backhand of that moment is amazing. Absolutely brilliant. So deep, right in that corner. That have such a relaxed arm and hand for that shot. Composure is what makes that shot impressive.
Enough guts to feed a village. I love my Nate song. Here we go, 8 points apiece.
Let it all.
Point in front once again. Chun Meng 2 points away from taking down someone who was recently the leading lady for the greatest rival to China, Team Japan. But if Hina Hayata gets this point, she's got the last two serve combination at 9-all in the fifth.
Leg 9-8.
Incredible point. Chun Meng recovered the net, and still the rally continued for back and forth, full out power here with the placement.
And she just wipes the nose and walks over to the towel box. It's like the moment in a movie where the hero walks over to the horizon with the explosion in the background.
I know that movie. Hashtag Finding Nemo. Here we go, 9 points apiece. This could be the last 2 points of the match. It's definitely the last two serve combination. Just keep swimming. It is match point for Chun Meng on the receive. One of the shortest rallies we've seen yet, with John Rue on the bench, other teammates, and Ma Lin behind her. The long push, not as much underspin as Hina Hayata thought was on it, and she quickly reviews that. Serve to tie it up. Hina Hayata against match point.
Leg 9-10.
These are some subtle mats, aren't they?
Sure are. Subtle and silky. And the backhand keeps her alive. Hina Hayata fighting. It is point for point now. They will alternate serves. Deuce in game number 5.
This is amazing yet tough to watch. She didn't make the same mistake twice, Hayata, there with the backhand third ball. How is she smiling in this moment? I would be bricking it.
This is training. This is not a coincidence. This is her forcing herself to think positive thoughts right now, to visualize the next point. Well, now, heavy spin, shallower on the table, that roar. I mean, from smiling the way we saw her to the roar right after that point, Coach Ishida trying to will her through. Stress on Ma Lin's side, trying to find some belief as well and send that on to Chun Meng. Could this be the third time in recent history that the upset has been pulled against the Olympic champion? Survival like you would not believe. I mean, every single time the ball came down, it just got better and better. Hina Hayata with some award-winning shots out here, let alone the match. And Chun Meng on top of them all, takes the legs out of Hina Hayata with that last backhand punch.
Oh my days. Well, at least if Hayata loses this match after having match points, she knows she couldn't have given much more. Oh, wow. 11-all in the fifth.
And a much different point out here. Chun Meng, tight serve in the follow-up, as focused as can be now. Match point for Chun Meng. Look at the fans. You can see tears already running here, the nerves in the crowd. But this is why Chun Meng is out there in the battlefield, because she keeps her composure in these moments. Chun Meng does it, 13-11, takes down Hina Hayata in an epic battle out here, and what could have gone either way. And a well-fought match indeed. Hina Hayata gave everything. Ma Lin, I will say, what a nerve-wracking performance. Ice in the veins with the potassium from before. Chun Meng is going to have to breathe this one off. Look at the scoreboard there after that 11-6 victory in game number 4. 13-11 saves match point and converts. Chun Meng really shining under pressure, and Ma Lin pounding his fists because this one was simply too intense.
Wow, with all her experience and all her jewelry there, Chun Meng for China, for herself, the difference between gold and silver. What a fight. Saves match point.
I can't believe she didn't end up on her back after that, but this, remember, was just a quarter final. It feels weird to use the word just. I mean, it was, that could have been the final. That was incredible. Looking on screen, anything stand out to you here?
I guess just the closeness in total points won. Serving was amazing from both in general. Probably the best match I've seen this entire event.
Well, let's hear from Chun Meng now.
Congratulations, Chun Meng. 恭喜你, Chun Meng. This is nice first match, and it's also very in this one. Hayata definitely didn't make it easy for you. What did you make of your game tonight? 这是今晚的第一场比赛，也是一场非常非常激烈的比赛。早田希娜的进攻对你也造成了很多的威胁。那你觉得这场比赛你打得如何？
今天晚上我觉得这场跟早田希娜的比赛，我觉得我们双方都发挥出了很好的水平吧，而且为大家也奉献了一场特别精彩的比赛。其实我觉得早田希娜这个选手，无论是从拼劲还是打法特点上，都是特别具有攻击力，包括她的整个实力，我觉得也非常强。而且近几年她的这个球的状态也是越来越好吧。在今天其实我在场上，我觉得一度还是很困难吧。最后能够赢下，能够拿下比赛，我觉得也是非常幸运吧。这场比赛也是能够让自己再去重回信心吧。希望在接下来继续去努力吧。
In this match, I believe we both sides played our best. We present a very exciting match.She is a very strong player and very aggressive. She is in her very good form in these years. During this match, I met some difficulties, but I'm very lucky to have the final win, and this boosts my confidence.
Xinxiang is proving to have worked close to both the players. It must be a good feeling. Say something to your fans. 在新乡，你得到了很多人的支持和欢呼声，相信你一定感觉非常棒，和你的粉丝说几句吧。
今天晚上我觉得能够赢下比赛，也是离不开现场的观众为我每一分赢球的呐喊吧。希望你们能够在接下来继续为我加油，谢谢大家。
Thank you for supporting me and cheering up for me. I can feel your enthusiasm and I become stronger on court. I hope you can continue to support me.Thank you.
Congrats to you again, 陈梦，谢谢陈梦。我们也期待你明天的比赛。
Congratulations indeed, Chun Meng. You can understand the boosted confidence that she must feel after that incredible battle to come back over such strong opposition in Hina Hayata, an epic match. We knew we might be in for something good, but who could have possibly predicted that it would be such high level, that level?Really just incredible. And Chun Meng takes the third spot. She's waiting for the winner of world number one, Sun Ying Sha, and Mima Ito of Japan. We'll have a chance to see that one today. But what's coming up next? Ooh, yeah, this should be good. The world number one, Fan Zhendong, the world champion, versus the bright, shining Lin Shidong, the future of Chinese table tennis. That right after this. man, I hope you got some hydration, maybe a breath of fresh air after that absolutely nail-biting performance, the match that felt like it could have been the match of the event. Chun Meng edging it out with some controversy. Well, not much controversy, but a whole lot of nerves. And a moment there where there was a little confusion about whose point it was, yet still, Chun Meng came out on top. Fan Zhendong and Lin Shidong up next. Sun Yingshan, Mima Ito to follow. And then the match at the end of the night, one that the world has been waiting for. Ruin Filus, the world's top chopper, versus the silent assassin, Lin Wenru of the Chinese Taipei team, but now world number one in the men's.
今天让我们请出世界排名第15位，来自中国的林旭东。Ladies
and gentlemen, let's welcome the world number 50 from China, Lin
Shidong。现在让我们欢迎世界排名第一，来自中国的范振东。Let's
welcome the world number 1 from China, Fan Zhendong. World
number one, and not by a little bit, by a long shot, yet he stays humble. Fan Zhendong was dominant at the Singapore Smash, the last major event that WTT had. This is their first ever meeting. The world number one, Fan Zhendong, versus the world number 15, who I wouldn't be surprised if we see reach world number one at some point, but I imagine Wang Chuqin might do it first. That said, either way, versus Chinese players, 67%, 17 more than his opponent, Fan Zhendong, with years of experience. This will be a best of five match, meaning the first player to win three games wins the match. Games played to 11 points, as it has been for over 20 years. Must win by two. So Li Lin, our umpire here, will be taking care of the coin toss and officiating the match to make sure everything is fair and square. No coaches on the benches, as both players represent the Chinese national team.
Lin Shidong, please.
It's a little hydration there for Lin Shidong. Interesting. Really taking his time there. I would have expected that from the older of the two players, Fan Zhendong. So as he gets his towel all set up in the box, gives his handshakes.
Toss, please. Black. Oh, white. Black, white. Black for you, white for you. Black, you win the toss. What do you want? And? Fan service or receives? Service. Good match.
So Fan Zhendong will serve and Lin Shidong will take the right side, or the left side of the table rather, but here on screen, the right side of the votes, just under 30% of fans online at worldtabletennis.com believe that Lin Shidong can win this match. Go there to worldtabletennis.com, cast your vote, let your opinion be heard for this match or the rest. I'm your commentator, Adam Bobro. Joining me, Fraser Riley. Fraser, let's talk about this man here.
Fan Zhendong, the world number one world champion.
Seemed like he was a similar age to Lin Shidong when he came through to win the German Open, beating the likes of Samsonov and Ovcharov. He dropped one game.
And here, the only game dropped to Lee Sang-soo after beating Felix Lebrun. So, good to see some crew out there. Vladi Diaz, Liu Hung, and Wang Hao, of course. Lin Shidong, 17 years old. World ranked number 15, only a pro for 1 year, and a 78% win record, not too shabby.
This kid is something else. I mean, his dispatch there of the world doubles champion, well, half of that, and the European champion without dropping a single plumbing game.
I think 7-10. Down against Christian Carlsen in the first and the third, didn't stop him. So, agility, resilience, $35,000. Waiting for the winner of the men's singles event.
Fan Zhendong versus Lin Shidong. Their first game, Fan Zhendong serve, love all.
All right, internet, let's see if your predictions are good here. Fan Zhendong, the strong favorite, understandable, but a young shot maker in red.
One
top of the
love.
Net, just over closing by a very little bit.
Slightly more slender figure. I know he's not fully developed compared to what he will be in a few years' time, but his power and timing, Lin Shidong, scary.
Oh, it was almost like how to play the net. I see what you tried to do on the first one. I'm going to show you how it's done. As low as he gets here, that ball just crawls over. The spin carries it away. Man, this is going to be, I don't want to say merciless because it's the same both ways, but no one can be taken lightly out here. Just a centimeter or two long, and it's ripped by Fang Zhendong.
This
is a crafty start here from Fang, despite the power that we just saw. Clever intention behind each shot. Sometimes the power can overshadow the intelligence of a shot.
We've talked about the totem pole and how many levels there are. Nice save. Not too many winning points against Fang Zhendong from that far behind, fishing him down.
Brilliant play from Fang. I mean, he's not exactly phased against younger, very strong opponents, is he? He beat Scholes 4-0 in the World Championship final, and he dispatched a Felix Lebrun 3-0 in the round of 32.
Big counter exchange here. We call him a shot maker because no matter where he is on the court, we can get a lot. Hey, speaking of Felix, he's texting his family. Guess what you've got to be watching? Right now I'm at WTT. So, while he's been eliminated from this event, he's going to be studying the world number one, figuring out his plans for next time.
2-5. That, 2-5.
So 3 points in front here, Fang Zhendong.
6-2.
There's so much to be said for experience here. It is just tough to imagine how many different things both of these players consider. Few have been able to stop Lin Shidong. Liang Jingqin just barely.
7-2.
And we still have a long way to go in this best of five, but Fang Zhendong right now has definitely appeared to teach a lesson or two already.
Fang Zhendong has added a lot of variation to his game. He used to be more route one, but now we see more flair from him.
A little bit off the top of the net to slow it down. What was that word that he used to be?
More route one, sort of direct. Attacks, but now you know he slows it up, he goes back a little bit more.
Interesting. I like learning new words, so I'll check it out. But I agree with you. I mean, he seemed to be very aggressive early on. The variation he's brought to his game has done him wonders, but Lin Shidong here in the touch game finding the opportunity over the table for the win. Much like Ma Long inside the table, full swing. He's not a very tall guy, Lin Shidong. Hence the Xiao Xiao part of the nickname.
7-5.
Time in there, right off the bounce. Goes racket angle and into the middle. Not so much the middle, I guess, there. Looked doable from Fan, but still, take nothing away from the shot of Lin.
Yeah, a parallel shot.
Yeah.
That's some of the power, the confidence that we see. It's a fine balance, this fearlessness with sort of adding variety when need be to adapt and adjust to the player's game, the opponent. But a one-point game now, what's that, 4 in a row? It was down 2-7.
You see timeouts being called early by players. But now it seems too late for Fang Zhendong to do that.
It might not be the perfect timing at this point. We'll see. Depends on what happens, but crafty touch play there to bring in Lin Shidong after he was backing off the table.
Six,
that backhand is so spring-loaded, the way he turns the wrist.
These flicks are so fast. And because the contact and racket speed is so quick, Lin Shidong twice in this game, I thought there was more topspin on it than there was.
What an unusual shot there from Lin Shedong early on. That said, it's Fang Shandong who gets the point. Enjoy one more time. Tomahawk chop block at baseline. You could see the ball just bite the table to stay closer to the net, or at least slow down in its move forward. And now four game points for the world number one. Jammed him up, found the middle.
The beauty of coming around the side of the ball with the flick. Not only does it make it more difficult to counter, but can almost disguise where you're going with it a little bit more.
Still surviving out here. Third towel break, and Fang Shandong just cleaning the rubber. You can see the backhand ready to crack back after a blocking forehand. Not too many are willing to just withstand the power that comes in from world number one and just hold the gloves up, a shield to block back. 8 serving 10. And he tried the short game.
Good change of service there to the shovel from Lin.
He adapted well to the push game. Fang Shandong, I thought, was clever to try playing the push. It worked out for him well. Personal coach. They love the face there. Oh, man. Out of reach and out of this world, out of game one, Fang Shandong. Victorious here. What an escape, 11-9, quite a comeback from 2-7 down. Lin Shedong putting up the good fight. Look how wide that ball is. Side and topspin just wrapped around and still had to play it on the line. So 11-9, the world number one over someone 9 years younger than him who might end up filling his shoes and then some, but we will see. 1-0, Fang Shandong leads.
Second game, Lin Shedong to serve. Lock all.
Players back for game number two. Lin Shedong with quite a comeback there. Some serious momentum, but just not enough in the end. Closed out Fang Shandong.
That, lock all.
The game was closed out by Fang Shandong, just to clarify.
Lock one.
What do you think we're going to see here, Fraser?
I think we're going to see more explosive rallies.
Anything in particular from Lin Shedong, change-wise?
Ooh.
Wow. One,
maybe more of that doing some favors.
A good serve to set it up, and then the third ball attack there. Very fluid, very free to just cleanly hit that shot down the line. But again, credit to the serve to earn him that third ball. Shot block against Fang Shandong. We gotta love the creativity. Players this explosive to have the feeling. Take a look. Oh man, like Ma Long. It's like a guillotine just chopping down.
Butchers it. It's interesting. And this may influence what happens here, but it seems like at this point in time, Lin Shedong might be the only player that could go backhand to backhand with Fang Shandong.
And look at their service percentages. Neither of them has won even 50% of their points on serve. Or I should say, has won 50% of their services.
3-1.
Because their flick game is so strong, right? So maybe we'll see more sort of short serve to the forehand.
It's just amazing how he's able to guide that ball back with the racket high. From the side, we watch this, and we get used to levels like, I mean, what we're seeing here. A little bit off the edge there. The ball just bending out of reach. But some serious momentum. Lin Shedong, the young Padawan, 75% of the last 8 points. How free does he look?
Five.
It's so casual for him. He's playing against the most explosive player in the game. Look at this. One, get ready for the follow-up. Just free and easy, plays it to the middle, side and topspin.
He's like a seasoned vet. Not just in the way that he plays, but his attitude towards each point and after the point, I've noticed Lin Shedong.
Yeah, he does care for animals a lot. That power once again, Lin Shedong. Not the first time we've seen that.
Oh. It'd be interesting to see how he could tame a snake.
Ah.
You see what I did there?
I did see what you did there. So quite a turnaround here. Oh, cool. Check out the right side of the screen. That was neat. One soft one comes in, and Fang Zhendong quickly taking advantage of a limited time opportunity.
Textbook Fang Zhendong.
Did you like it, is the question, Lin Shedong. Please show us without words.
Set three.
Now, if there were a coach in the corner, tough to know, but I think at this point, again, when you don't have coaches on your bench, you tend to see timeouts a little bit later. We've seen a lot of mental maturity from this 17-year-old, Lin Shedong. Good court awareness and, you know, able to step back.
4-6.
So now the serves are going to be with Fang Zhendong. Well, there is a massive momentum switch here after that 6-1 shot we saw three in a row.
4-6.
Lin Shedong going for a little walk, but quickly brought back to the table. Thanks to our umpire. Good call. The classic serve, but handled as perfectly as can be on that receive.
Beautiful. Reverse pendulum from Fang. Serve that Zhang Jike had a similar kind of toss and contact too.
Yeah, eerily similar, you might say. But well handled.
That 4-7.
Interesting that he goes back to it, considering what happened on the last receive.
That 4-8.
So even though he said let, it was on the assumption that the ball would come down on the other side of the table. A service gift here. And Lin Shedong, 4 points up, gets the serves back. Not a bad set of receives there. Second one most impressive because he just won it with his mind. Oh, man, it hurts. Spanked. I mean, there are a lot of ways to punish a server, but little conversation might help here. That receive just so confident.
Unreal, and it stems from that short shovel serve again.
Getting low, no problem. Six game points. I mean, remember the way game number one started? It looked like we weren't even going to have a match on our hands, that it would just remind us that there's a major difference between world number one and world number 15, but not quite the story.
Five.
Good tight serve, that reverse pendulum.
Hot. Beautiful. Really got to look at the logo on the ball if you're not too sure.
Turn six.
Whatever the fortune was, Fang Zhendong quick to acknowledge it as he takes another stab at saving a game point. And does so, two game points saved, four more to go. For Lin Shedong.
It's a better conversion rate behind the serves now from Fan, though, I will say that.
Well, in the receive game, it was trouble here. The shovel serve for Lin Shedong, and it is tied up. Quite a statement here, 11-6 in game number two. So Lin Shedong, you have to wonder. Again, Fang Zhendong won the Singapore smash over Ma Long with authority in their last encounter. Lin Shedong showing quite strong in game number two. Let's enjoy some slow-mo of the future star himself.
Third game, Wan Zhendong to serve. Love all.
So a real change here as Lin Zhidong takes the steering wheel, driving it home 11-6 in game number two.
Love
I mean,
one.
We just turn our heads and look at each other in the commentary booth to get that much speed. Look at the trajectory on this ball. Even in the replay, Fan Zhendong was there just a moment after the ball had passed.
Wow. Best use of the rubber, that is.
Two love.
What an interesting clash here between the world champion and the world youth champion, actually. Lin Zhidong.
Good pressure and placement from the world number one, Fan Zhendong. If they were wrestling, they wouldn't even be in the same class. But power out here just goes to show you how much timing matters, speed, coordination. When I say coordination, I don't mean like the ability to catch a ball. I mean using your body in sync, coordinating everything together. Nima Ito is a great example of that as well. She's tiny.
Man.
1-4.
That time going the longer length of the table. But an even bigger use of wrist there. Fluid like water, Lin Zhidong.
Which is interesting because Fan Zhendong loves Bruce Lee.
Oh, I saw the Ask a Pro Anything vid.
Yeah.
5-1.
So once again, a very compelling score line here, favoring Lin Zhidong. I mean, when you think about the players in recent history who've beaten Fan Zhendong, including Cho Dae-sung, it just makes you realize anything is possible with a player like Lin Zhidong out here on the table. It's unbelievable. Explosive. We're talking, I mean, I've been calling Fan Zhendong the most explosive player in the game for years. But that's partially because Lin Zhidong wasn't on the radar. I feel like there's someone who really likes that title and wants to take it over.
And I've been saying Darko Jorgic of Slovenia has had the best backhand against the dead ball for years, but could be this man as well, this 17-year-old. Some of the shots he was hitting on the way to reaching that star contender Goa final, where he nearly beat Liang Jingquan. Similar to this level.
Interesting.
Three, six.
The placement of that serve, from where we were watching that, it appeared to sit up a little bit higher, but because of the placement, it's quite unpredictable. Serve to be effective. Similar place, but a different delivery here, and a much better response on the receive this time around to extend the lead back to four.
I don't know, I feel like Fan Zhendong might be better off doing the reverse pendulum.
He was one of three. I mean, he missed one serve doing that, got ripped on the first one, and then got the third point. I just remember that sequence. That's all I can remember about that.
7-4.
Anything else that you think? I mean, he did play two unusual placements in a row, so.
Yeah. I don't know. I haven't said this much, but Fan Zhendong is losing a lot of the open rally, so maybe he needs to revert back to that divisiveness and try and slow things down.
Let.
Service warning.
Not autogolly.
The toss
seven,
must be
four.
No more than 30 degrees off of perfectly vertical.
Let. 7-4.
Nice adjustment made by Lin Zhidong. If he doesn't, could cost him the point. Beautiful backhand again as he follows.
Getting flashbacks the last time he was in Xinjiang. Fan Zhendong, he lost the Dima, didn't he? Quite prematurely.
I think, what, the third time Dima's won against Fan Zhendong?
Yeah, the first time he'd beaten him in China. Well, sorry, first time he'd beaten him outside of the German Open.
Both true, though.
Yeah.
As fast as can be,
four,
it comes
nine.
In fast. I was going to say, you don't need as much backswing. when the ball comes in that fast, but it still seems like he's adding a very compact yet impressive level of aggression to counter those shots. Fang Zhendong down by 5, big serve here to start a long comeback.
9-5.
Reverse pendulum, it's what you asked for.
Yeah. Didn't necessarily mean long, but that one working well, maybe could be good. I mean, if you don't want to have to make the adjustment from in and out, a long serve can be good. You're already there.
You have to be specific when you wish for something.
Ooh, didn't wish for that.
Oh, Lin Shidong Jiao. I was just thinking, forgot the name of it. Lin Shidong fan club here. Oh, he's got it. Love it. Lin Shidong Jiao on the screens there. Some dimples behind. Long rally keeps Fang Zhendong passive behind. The danger of the power that Lin Shidong has is a reason why Fang Zhendong can't comfortably counter.
Such mature play. Miraculously, you got that one out of the middle, but then instead of going for a big killer, slow spin.
It was pretty odd that he even played the way he did out of the middle. You don't see him play that way, so sort of passively. That said, 4 game points for Lin Shidong.
7-10.
Fearless again. What are you thinking, Fraser?
Tries to finish it in style. I mean, the way he seems, Lin Shidong, it's almost like he's the world champ and Fang Zhendong's the upcoming 17-year-old.
It does feel that way at this point in time. 3 game points left for Lin Shidong.
10,
but a bit more Fang Zhendong-like out here. Fang Zhendong gets that free ball after the setup on the serve. Pendulum long, perfectly to the corner. Has to get low to play that to the middle and loads it with spin.
Doing Fang Zhendong things right now. Fang Zhendong.
We just take turns saying Fang Zhendong twice, back and forth. And the touch does it. The soft hands, explosive as can be. Xiao Xiao Pong, Lin Shidong. He has done a lot in recent history, but most recently, he just won another game against Fang Zhendong to take a 2-1 lead. Looking casual. Yes, he is. 11-6, 11-8. The world number 15 is one game away from eliminating a man who is heads above the rest. Speaking of top of the food chain, in 1 year, how much can you do for world rankings? Anyone who would move up 400 world rankings, you would think might be 900 moving to 500. But he just moved up from 415 to 4, well, to 15. He moved all the way up to 414, no. He moved up to 15 in the world. A lot of familiar names here. That's everyone else here, the biggest movers and participants. Felix LeBron is one of them. Hey, it's me. Little charm there. Fans love him. You could hear him. They should show him more often. Whenever the crowd starts to just get a little bit nervous, I want to see what happens. Listen to the crowd if they show Felix LeBron's face. It's amazing. Wait. Wait.
First game. Lin Shidong, sir. Love. Oh.
Good times, good times. He may or may not outgrow that charm. I think it'll stick with him. Good times here. Speaking of somebody only a year older than Felix LeBron, 17-year-old Lin Shidong. And he starts off this game strong.
Well, well, well.
I think the audience was just too focused cheering on Fang Zhendong. Had they noticed Felix LeBron there, they would have started cheering. Oh, the backhand. You watch him just sort of fiddle the racket before he settles in his grip, and then out of nowhere, an explosion.
And there's basically no backswing, so there's no indication either as to where he's going to go with it.
We need a phantom cam to see that racket. Even in slow-mo, it was a blur. How does he move so quickly?
Time up.
Dodge this. He is the one. He is Neo. He is just moving on another plane right now, and a timeout on Fang Zhendong's side. Down 0-3. Shaking his head here. Not in a position he'd love to be in. Imagine you had Fang Zhendong's skill sets just for a minute. Calm down. Now, what would you do down 0-3 in game 4, 1-2 behind?
tactically, it's tough to say right now against Lin Sedong, but I would try to delay things as much as possible if I was fine. Draw out the time between serves, do a lap around the court, around the Infinity Arena, after each point.
You're dirty. You're really like, I do everything until I get a yellow card. That's basically what would happen. Coming up next, we've got Sun Ying Sha, the world number one, versus Mima Ito. They've got quite an interesting history. Mima's mom in the background and Mima-chan right there, getting ready. Interesting. A lot to look forward to here in the Infinity Arena. Back from his timeout, quickly takes the first point with a tight serve to the forehand side. The shoes of Fan Chundong there.
Going down the pace. Not extending. Just caressing it back there after a strong flick. There we see it.
Again, there are a lot of different ways to be brave. Sometimes slowing it down, as you mentioned, can be just that. He tries, but Lin Sedong takes control once again.
It's almost like in the mirror, you're playing in the mirror against Lin. The more you give, the more you get back, because it's almost the exact same coming back at you, but better.
You know, as mature as Lin Sedong is, there's no question. With 9 years more of experience, Fan Chundong has more to pull from in this game. So I think it is wise to try and slow it down, but Lin Sedong is not making his job easy. He's really taking every opportunity. And we've seen the touch play from Lin Sedong as well. Soft hands right there to earn that attack, and it's so effortless from him on that fourth ball. Little virtual face palm there, slap of the forehead, not completed, but intended there, signaled by Fan Chundong.
Took
a combination of attacks in this rally from Fan Chundong to get the best of Lin Sedong.
Just for a little bit of context here, obviously they haven't played on the WTT stage, but in the China warm-up matches for the World Championships that Fan Chundong won, Lin Sedong lost to him 4-1.
And that was quite recently, yeah?
Yeah. About a season and a half ago.
So Lin Sedong, almost 60%, about 12%, just over 12% better on the serves that he has. That said, since the timeout, Fan Chundong has done quite well to level the playing field. He was down 0-3 and has won 5 of the next 7 points.
Two slower balls. It's not the hard shots that are winning it for Fan.
It's tough to get on top of that backhand. I like the body language of Lin Sedong. It lets us inside his mind. At least a bit. You have a sense of what he's thinking when you see him rehearsing how he would have played that should it come up. Sort of if he has another chance. A nice long push here. He's clever.
Have you ever seen a 17-year-old Adam as good as Lin Sedong?
From the start of that sentence, when you paused, I was going to say, yes, I've seen many 17-year-olds, but as good as Lin Sedong, maybe.
Relatively.
Maybe only the person standing on the other side of the table. It's the only person who comes to mind at 17.
So many fans around the world at this point.
Ooh. Of Fan Chundong, fans of Fan Chundong, or fans of Lin Sedong?
Fans of table tennis.
Yeah, that's what's up. 7-5.
7-6.
And let's not forget, Tomokazu Harimoto at 15 years old was world number 3.
But I guess if we're going off shot-making ability, yeah.
Lin Sedong has got to be one of the greatest at 17 ever.
6-8.
It's an exchange rate that Fan Zhendong cannot afford at this point in the match. Wang Hao watches Vladi Diaz there. The crowd just really loving the reactions and the facial expressions they've gotten. I'll bet we'll get some screenshots on social media of the different faces of Wang Hao.
6-9.
Parallel forehand there at the back of the table. To me, the thing is, Lin Shedong has so many answers. Think about everything that Fan Zhendong has brought out. Shaw something toe. Interesting.
9-7.
I think Shato is the fan club of Sun Yin Shao and Wang Chuchun.
Yeah, but that was little something head. Rock Oshato. Got it. Stone. Little rock. I like it. Lin Shedong is the capital of Arkansas. Tomahawk chop
nine,
block
eight.
In the follow-up. But Fan Zhendong is within 1 point. We got a timeout now on Lin Shedong's side. Wow. Not easy to do. Heavy side spin comes in. Perfect calibration from Fan Zhendong.
That's the second time we've seen a Chiquita and then Lin Shedong go for the forehand chop block. Fan Zhendong with his power just comes through on both occasions.
I want to be the thoughts of Fan Zhendong, excuse me, Lin Shedong right now. If it comes even close to the baseline, forehand rip, soft touch cross court, backhand opening. I mean, you have to imagine he's just covering all his bases right now. But he's got to serve, one left to set up a match point. Service-wise, that shovel serve has been really strong. Man,
hi.
This has been an incredible champions event so far, and we're not even to the semifinals.
If we can pull this off here, Lin Shedong.
9-8.
The fact that he hasn't even been selected for the singles of the World Championships is only going to instill more fear of a player outside of Team China coming up against one of their men.
Half-long serve. Where is it coming from? Fan Zhendong has called his timeout, and so has Lin Shedong. It is two match points to eliminate the world number one, not by a little, the world number one by a mile, courtesy of someone who was not selected to represent China in Durban, South Africa. Thought he had done it, maybe. That first shot was so good, and there was just a little pause in the follow-up attack. Fan Zhendong staying strong here. And a break off the net, quite frankly, helped out quite a bit. Oh, interesting. Shush. 10. It's 9 serving 10. And it almost comes down again. What a save. Fan Zhendong really tight now. I thought the luck had balanced out here after the net that Fan Zhendong had the point before, but he recovers the net ball.
And if he sends that ball really long there, it's over. It's just short enough to stop Lin Shedong from making a winner after the net he got.
I mean, we saw maybe one of the scariest finishes of a match in terms of Hina Hayata and Chun Meng just before this, but it's another match point for Lin Shedong.
That's the first time I can recall hearing him chill and get a vocal.
Yeah, quite vocal, as you could see. Third match point for Lin Shedong. Imagine a point going this long with the quality of shots that they bring. Fan Zhendong recovers everything. Lin Shedong up to the task time and time again. Out of this world. speechless out of.
Can
seriously.
The backhands that we saw Lipsadon hit, and it just came back. Balls to the wall and balls on the table. When he needed to, Fan, he didn't have a choice in the matter.
Well, I understand the intention there, and there's no question about it. Quite a different point out here after an incredible rally. One of the best rallies. Hey, he's got teeth. He's got teeth. Wong Hao entertained Bloody Diaz behind him. Six of the last 8 points to Fan Zhendong. That's crazy considering where they are in the game. From 8-10. Look at him now. Game point. And the net. The net. Have you seen Lin Shidong collapse like that on the table? He had 10-8. He had 10-8 against Liang Jingquan not too long ago in Goa.
That's a good point, Adam. I don't know how he hasn't won the game. I don't know how Fan Zhendong has stole it. This is one of the best fights the world champions ever had to make.
It has just been spectacular to watch. The legs there, Fan Zhendong sliding and getting so low. The fact that he keeps his body intact. He's going to need a big shower towel to wipe off after that game. 13-11, and it sends it to the D, to the side, to the dirt. Game number five with world number one. Wow. The battle will continue here. So serious momentum with the world number one, saving multiple match points. Fired up right out of the gates, that first point. What are you thinking?
I'm still reliving that match point save from Fan. I need to press the reset button myself here, Adam.
I encourage that. No, it truly was amazing. I mean, we're all watching that with our jaws dropped, thinking Lin Shidong hitting the shots he's hitting surely is winning the match with these shots. Yet Fan Zhendong has different plans.
It's one of those matches now. This one of these situations where you genuinely can't tell who the momentum's with. But a nice, long, fast, deep push. Lin Shidong, the world youth champion.
Two, four.
2 points apiece now. Fan Zhendong, point for point. We've seen him overcome some very difficult, challenging, high pressure moments already in game four. So 1 point in front now. You can hear the crowd really appreciating the points that they're putting on out here. I think we knew coming up in this one that we'd have some big rallies. Fast feet, a lot of power. How do you even see the ball in real time, let alone counterspin? It's tough to keep track of. It's out of this world. Look at the team doc for Bloody Diaz. Wong Hao's got teeth. We know they're there. Polkanova. This quality, that backhand from behind the table, this is just going to inspire generations and generations, even within the Chinese team. Fan Zhendong has to sideswipe that ball to hit it so that it doesn't come back.
I mean, what words can do this level of table tennis justice? This is insane, literally insane.
Chop block, ripping power. He's 17, Lin Shidong. We knew he was good. I mean, you think of the point of the century, 2015 World Championships Men's Singles Final. You think of the 2017 final at the World Championships. The quality of point that we're getting out here is some of the best I've ever seen. It's just jaw-dropping, the amount of power, precision, and fearlessness that we're seeing in these long rallies. Fan Zhendong, the fan club here. Will he look like that after this match?
Five,
the violent
four.
Bandit is what they said out there. He's a gentle man, he's humble, but when he's on the table, he's hard-hitting and merciless.
Man, you can say that about both. Kind of similar auras about them.
Hey, big smile from Fan Zhendong. Despite the point going against him. A little bit of irony there. Perfect placement on that serve. He got Lin Shidong to think he knew what he needed to do. And then he had to second guess himself. And when it cost him in time, he made a passive shot that really set up the third ball for the world number one.
Yeah, it was nice, a nice fade there from Fan.
A pancake
five,
flip.
Six.
He comes in and he shows push. It looks like push, and then he quickly turns it over. Watch this one more time. Nope. Okay, from this camera angle, looks a little bit more clear, but a very open face of the racket for that
play.
Extra bit of deception.
5-6.
Forehand flick, one of the toughest shots in the game. Not a lot of spin to work with.
That, 5-6.
Well, the let change where he decides to go.
I don't understand.
Six, oh.
I've been watching a lot of table tennis over the years. I think I know where power comes from and when you can generate so much.
It's unplayable. It's unplayable.
It's like he has a generator in his pocket. Like he can be mid-air and just suddenly there's power that you didn't even realize.
There's a wire connected from his blade through to his arm down to underneath the flooring.
Wouldn't be surprised if there's a brand looking to capitalize on that. Good marketing. But a clean shot takes the legs out of Lin Shidong. Rare that we've seen him off balance for a moment.
Didn't do much wrong with the receive there. Into the temptation zone of Fan, into the middle. And hit a winner out of the middle.
Yeah, he's trying hard here. Fan Zhendong's putting in that extra percent to just make sure he can surprise the opponent.
7-0.
7 points apiece. Last game was quite intense, but here we are once again.
It's a good job we're not in COVID times now, because imagine how many times this table would have had to have been wiped by the assistant.
Oh, man. Due to the wide forehand, that has been a sweet spot for Fan Zhendong. He's looking for any opportunity to catch Lin Shidong, in quotes, out of position, just finding any opening he can, as wide as can be, with side spin on it as well.
Play.
Bends the wrist.
Seven, eight.
Two miraculous winners there, Fan.
Interesting. Seemed long enough. I mean, we both immediately sat up in our seats as if to say, I can't believe he gave that serve loose.
I wonder how intentional the bounciness of that serve was from Lin Shidong.
Yeah, it looked odd.
Because sometimes the bounciness can tempt you into the attack, but then if it's loaded with backspin as well,
right.
Tough.
9-8.
Outright service point here from Fan Zhendong. Can you imagine if he looked down at his racket and there was a wet spot on it? He did look down at the racket. The ball came off it quite unusually. Be a tough time to have to replay a point. As the server, it is your responsibility to clean the ball to keep it dry before the point starts. power. It is the power that we've seen from Lin Shidong throughout. And despite saving multiple match points, Fang Zhendong now has two of his own.
He has earned the respect of the entire world, Lin Shidong, no matter what happens here. But Fang, I mean, showing true qualities of a world champion. I know Ma Long wasn't there in Houston, but here, I mean, this is a world beater.
And he counters back for the win. What a way to finish. And his back against the ropes in game number four. It looked like it was over. The world number one not only survives, but thrives and strives to take the title here. He was unstoppable in Singapore. What a nerve-wracking match once again, just when you thought it couldn't get any better. It came down to 11-8 in the fifth. Two incredible matches in a row. And right now, simply satisfaction. I'll bet he's got to be shaking inside right now after that match.
One of the best encounters I have ever seen in the 10 years I've been watching table tennis. He had to save match points there, Fan, in the fourth as well.
And as you said, the quality of point was just mind-blowing. If Lin Shidong gets any faster or stronger, which it seems reasonable that he would, the player with more points was the one who has beaten Lin Shidong, 50-49, but it's the first player to win three games. Fang Zhendong pulling through after that 11-6 victory in game number two. Other than that, it was the comeback of Fang Zhendong. So the world has a lot to look forward to in Lin Shidong, but strong and on top of the world, Fang Zhendong. Let's hear from the world number one, Xiaopeng, right now on court.
Congratulations, Zhendong. Your opponent certainly didn't make it easy for you. How did you stay calm and win?
恭喜你，樊振东，今天你的对手给你制造了很多的麻烦，那你是如何在场上保持冷静并且赢下比赛的？我觉得今天确实非常困难嘛，然后其实一度也是感觉可能很难去逆转了，但是最后还是。 憋着一口气，然后一直在想办法，最后能够赢回来，我觉得对自己来说，还是非常大的收获吧。Yes,
indeed, it was a tough match. Sometimes I felt I couldn't come back, but I didn't give up and busy to find solutions. It's a great achievement for me to win at last.
And your form is looking good this match. Can you go all the way to win? 今天这场比赛你的状态非常的好，那你能够一直保持这样的状态赢下去吗？
我觉得今天其实最后自己赢下了比赛，但是过程中还是有很多这种起伏吧。一场比赛我觉得也很正常。那最后我认为到了关键时刻自己的处理还是做得不错吧。
Even though I won the match at last, there were ups and downs. It is very normal for a match. I handled some crucial shots.
Thank you. Congratulations again. 让我们再次恭喜樊振东。
Well, I would call that match anything but normal, quite exceptional, but Fang Zhendong reminding us that between Chinese Super League and the sport at the highest level, there are some incredibly tense moments that you have to overcome, and Fang Zhendong has done just that. He will face Lim Jong-hoon in the next round. So we've got one more spot up for grabs. Who's it going to be, Ruin Filus or Lin Win Ru? Curious to see what the internet has to say. WorldTableTennis.com. Cast your vote in the match center. Just look under results, and you'll see there your chance to express your opinion. But coming up next, well, there's an opinion that the history recently has been quite strong in favor of Sun Yingxia against Japan's Mima Ito. The rivalry of our generation, this match coming up next. We'll be right back. Well, I hope you've had a chance to catch a breath, because the Infinity Arena right now has been taking the wind out of the lungs of nearly everybody here. The last two matches have been breathtaking. Here's a look at what we've had so far. Chun Meng 3-2, saved match points with Hina Hayata. Hina Hayata was incredible, and Chun Meng just enough better to win. And then Fan Zhendong the same against Lin Shidong in a five-game battle. Sunying Sha and Mima Ito up next. We will see if Mima Ito can turn things around as of recent history. And then following that, the world will be watching the world's best chopper, Ruan Filus, versus the silent assassin, Lin Win Ru.
Ladies
and gentlemen, let's welcome the world number 6 from Japan, Mima Ito!
此刻让我们用欢呼声请出世界排名第一来自中国的孙沙。
So the world number one, the world has loved her from the time she showed up on the scene at 16 years old. She climbed the rankings quickly, has been bopping around like Mario. And 8-2, that is her head-to-head, meaning 80% of the time, over 10 encounters, she has won against Mima Ito, the world number 6. In the top 10, wow, nearly twice the time. That just goes to show you how long Mima Ito has been playing professionally. Think about how many weeks, 326? My goodness, 52 weeks in a year. We're talking over 6 years in the world top 10. That's incredible for someone so young. Speaking of young, it's Kim Young-ju, our umpire for the match, who will be officiating, starting off with the coin toss here. That is where we will determine who serves and where the players stand. Front row with a flash, that's not going to last long.
Left, yeah, left. Service, yeah, receive.
So Mima Ito chooses to serve after winning the coin toss. They know each other's equipment quite well. Mima Ito with some different equipment. We'll talk about that in a bit. I'm your commentator, Adam Bobro, and with me, Fraser Riley. Fraser, what's going on in your life?
Just commentating table tennis and absolutely loving sport, loving the action here in Xingshan. Feel very blessed to be here.
Understandable. You got 22-year-old Sunying Sha, the best in the game right now, the most unbeaten woman in the world, world number one by a long shot. Not a game drop to Du Hoi Kim. And Yang Xiaoxin took one game off in the round of 16. Monaco's long pitch attacking backhand player. Could that be a good warm-up for the style we're about to see out here with Mima Ito and her short pitch backhand?
I think so. I mean, it seems that it's so effective if you don't know how to play it, but the top Chinese women have, as they did with Miu Hirano after she won the Asian Cup in 2017.
So Mima Ito over Suthasini Sowetabut of Thailand, 3-0. And after that, you saw the result there on screen. Mima Ito looking strong so far. Remember, they're playing for $35,000 and 1,000 points. Right now, each of them has already earned $14,500. It's interesting to rally, to have someone blocking with short pips. Sometimes you'll see someone turn the racket around. The fan vote is in, Mima Ito. Now remember, I don't know. I believe this is who they believe will win. I think Japan is online right now.
Yeah, it seems that way, right? I mean, the betting man would put their money on Sunying Sha.
Sunying Sha versus Ito Mima. First game.
Who knows?
Ito Mima to serve. Love all.
But this is always interesting how the internet works. It depends who it is you're getting it from, the source. So just a reminder, you can cast your vote on worldtabletennis.com. We'll see. Mima Ito to start off with the serves.
One love.
Arguably the best server in the game, Mima Ito.
One all.
So as one of the best servers in the game, she plays high-risk serves. From time to time, there will be an omiyage, a souvenir, something that doesn't come down on the table. Step behind the table. Mima Ito's game is going to be tough. She's been clocked as having the fastest reaction times in the game when she was playing against Ding Ning a few years ago. It was said that her reaction time was 10 times as fast based on the statistics. Now, a big part of that is Ding Ning was getting behind the table, but Sun Ying Sha not behind in score line so far. Pendulum serve keeps it deep, low enough that Mima Ito's slightly flatter backhand doesn't have the odds.
I think she's trying to compensate for the fact that she can't produce as much varying spin from the backhand, Mima Ito, by really varying and working on her artistry from it, such as the strawberry and the banana.
Yeah, just adding in side spin where she can.
Four,
a nice
two.
Placement on this serve, sort of a modified tomahawk there, somewhere between a tomahawk and a shovel serve. Again, if you're just joining us, you're newer to table tennis. The serve must hit your side first, then the opponent's side. A long serve will come off the table, a short serve will get a second bounce, but most of the serves, players are serving half long to cause hesitation. You can't tell if it'll come off the table or not.
Tried to really brush over that. Seemed quite upright when she played that forehand, Sun Ying Sha, compared to her usual silhouette. Oh, beautiful switching on the table there, just stretching the short statured Ito as much as she could.
Close up there of the look at what's on the backhand side of Mima Ito, those short pips. Tough to rally with. She takes the ball so early off the bounce. Now, if you're newer to table tennis, those short pips, those bumps you see on the red side of Mima Ito's racket means less spin. So she plays fast and flat. She can still spin the ball, but just not quite as much as she can with the forehand side of the racket. All day right now, she's found a sweet spot on the table, and if she keeps it surprising, you have to wonder if every once in a while she'll throw in some serve just to sort of cleanse the palate and keep Sun Ying Sha guessing.
We love the Sakura service, don't we?
Yes, we do. Yes, we do.
Let 5-4.
That serve, net receive. It's okay. Shoes of Sun Ying Sha out here. Edge of the table, but she's going for it.
Really trying to pressure Sun Ying Sha early on. You have to, right?
She did a good job of moving her into the middle of the table by playing the elbow. I mean, Sha Sha could have turned for the forehand, but Mima Ito good on top of the bounce. Quality rally here, quick recovery as Ito gets the top of the net. Scoreline, again, it's been a long time. For me, it was 1 point at 4-4 in the fast five at T2. Just 1 point for Mima Ito to beat Sun Ying Sha. But Mima Ito right now seems to be capturing the momentum. Six of the last 8 points have been that of Mima-chan.
Eight.
Wow, backspin into a similar kind of region.
Yeah, I was interested to see that she went back to the same placement, although in some senses, until your opponent proves that they have a good answer for it, yeah, it's the service spin variation there that really saved her. How many serves in a row have been right on that forehand line? I mean, it's, again, if it ain't broken, don't fix it. She just keeps pounding on that spot, and it keeps rewarding her. Unbelievable resilience. It's a lot of work for Sasha to win this point. The eyebrows of Ma Lin, I think, say quite a lot.
The angles that they both maneuvered.
That punch behind the table. Mima Ito does not have the biggest steps. Behind the table is no Mima land. Quick counter, racket high. I mean, this is a page out of the Chinese national team with that forehand. Watch the stroke of Mima Ito in this. The way she finished, it's very un-Mima-like, but it wins her the point, and now she's got four game points. Fast long serve, the first time in what, seven serves, and it's gone to the opposite corner to win the game outright, 11-6. What a turnaround here.
Fascinated to see, and it's the second time I've seen this actually in the Infinity Arena. Mima Chan doesn't have a coach in the corner, and she belongs to a team that has plenty of finance and infrastructure and coaches, so why do you think that could be?
Well, she answered this yesterday. I don't think you were here for that match, but it has been a conversation point. It's been a little bit of a private talking point from her, but it was asked on court. I'll answer that in a moment. A look at the world rankings here. Sunying Sha number one, Mima Ito number six. I mean, more than three times the points Sunying Sha of Mima Ito. Wow. And nearly 3,000 points above Wang Manyu, who was eliminated by Chen Xingtong. So it's going to be more scramble below the world number one. But if Mima Ito can continue this way, it would bring Sunying Sha and Mima Ito closer together, either by world rankings or by points. So in terms of why she doesn't have a coach, there is no clear answer. She basically said she feels that, you know, she can do what she needs to do out here. She's still training with the coach, but she feels prepared on her own. One day I will say I did it. That was the quote from Sunying Sha that you saw on the poster there. So yeah, Mima Chan's been playing without a coach on the coaching bench for some time now. Singapore didn't see it. Interesting.
Yeah.
Coach Motz is still here though and training her. And this is interesting, you know, some players just don't want, like with parents, right? Your parents have to wait outside the gym sometimes when you're playing. You don't want to be able to see them. Sit far away so I don't have to hear or see your face when I miss a shot. Sometimes it's just extra pressure, but yeah, she's free.
I'm the same. I don't like having someone in the corner telling me what to do. I like figuring things out on my own.
Yeah, that's right. I don't like being told what to do either. Soft flick, good placement here from Sunying Sha. So 1 point apiece now. It's funny, I thought I heard something in my ear, but I realized there was nothing. So Mima Ito splits the first 2 points. Still leading in games.
2-1.
The crowd reminding Sunying Sha where she is. 12 of the last 16 points won by Mima Ito.
It almost seems brave at the moment for Sunying Sha to go into the back end of Ito initially like that.
She's doing a better job of receiving Sunying Sha. She had a lot of trouble early parts. If you didn't have context right there, that body language would be quite mysterious. Mima Ito, very expressive.
She was casting a spell.
Yeah. Maybe she was.
Yeah. Shots like that.
I just imagine Mima Ito over a cauldron with like a stirring pot and a hat. Beautiful angle there, that short stroke. The ball barely bounces at all off that forehand rubber. If you've ever played with the Chinese national team racket, it's so heavy and hard, that forehand. Very good in the short game. But a nice long push in that short game. Comes in over the table, takes it right off the bounce, and surprises Mima Chung.
I feel like Sun Yin Sha can do a better job of not just playing it straight into the backhand. Make it a little bit more middle. Just to make it harder there for Mima to kind of make any kind of adjustment.
Yeah,
she'll stand very biased on the backhand side, like a lot of players do, right?
Right, and she did a good job there of hitting the middle as Mima was moving. Flat Mima smash from behind the table. The rally was juicy as can be.
Again, that initial forehand of Sun Yin Sha. The awareness of where the back line is and where the ball's coming to blows my mind.
To me, the fact that even in the slow-mo replay, Mima's attacks, it was like they never happened. She finished every stroke completely ready.
5-3.
And they're just so quick. They're so short, the strokes.
Yeah. So abrupt.
So 2 points in front here. Sun Yin Sha with a bit of momentum. You gotta love the quality of point here. Sha Sha behind the table keeps the pressure on, and Mima right on top of every bounce, doing everything she can to stop the world number one.
Spectacular. Spectacular. Dealing better with the serves now, Sun Yin Sha. That was an off-to-off touch, the backhand touch from the forehand side.
Six,
excellent change
five.
Of direction, helped with a bit of fortune. Big pressure point this one. Serving from the forehand side now.
6-4.
Sha Sha there going for an all or nothing down the line shot. Mima Ito is showing fantastic initiative here. Look at the side spin. Painting that purple line perfectly. Purring now, Mima Ito. She levels 6-0.
That's long serve into the body, and Sha Sha continuing. Again, this is sort of a must win. Well, let's put it this way. To go down 0-2 would give a lot of encouragement to a player who's beaten Sun Yin Sha twice before. It's not a must win, but it sure would help. And in these backhand-to-backhand rallies, it feels that Sun Yin Sha is getting a bit more dialed in, comfortable against the flat shots that come at her. Remember, Mima can produce topspin with those short pips, and does in that rally, but not nearly as much. They're relatively flat compared to what you're used to off a backhand. I'm trying to remember when Mima was serving, and she was serving from the backhand corner to the forehand line. I don't remember any long streak of wins on the receive from Sun Yin Sha, but she's definitely gone away from that serve.
Nice intricate play. Sinyin Shah getting the looser of the balls, and yeah, borderline suicide pushing long and high to Sinyin Shah. She'll put that away.
So four game points now for the world number one to tie up the score. Only needs the one, 11-6. A gift absolutely mirrored and returned. That 11-6 victory in game one for Mima Ito has been even. 17 points apiece, quite a statement in the second. And we'll see, it's going to be a lot of feeling out for serves in the short game for Mima Ito to figure out if she can cause some trouble. Momentum with the world number one, Sinyin Shah. Biggest fan club here.
Third game. Ito Mima to serve. Lock all.
So Baby Buddha back at the table. The world number one. After an 11-6 victory, it's Mima Ito who has some answers to find. There it is.
One.
Goes back to that modified tomahawk serve to the forehand. I mean, she won game one on a fast, long serve to the backhand, but nothing else.
That first point's huge for Ito because she lost the last 5 points before that.
Very unusual play here. A few shots back to back that came off just a bit awkward.
Yeah, let's have a look at that. So surprisingly slow and spinny, and then came off in a similar way from the short pips.
So some momentum here for Sinyin Shah, six of the last eight. You're right, it was tied up at 6-6 in the last game, and then not a point dropped from the world number one.
One, two.
Good wide angle here early with the Mima punch. That's the backhand punch that we see her deliver so effectively here.
She tried to bluff Mima again by going for a similar serve. The Mima punch. I don't know. Feels like Mima has a stamp on a lot of her shots that you can name after her.
A few of them you'll hear a lot throughout this match.
Three, four.
Gets into the point well, but this serve is not going to always equal a point converted. Again, subtle variations on that serve to the forehand side. If it was exactly the same every time, Sinyin Shah for sure would have found easy answers by now. And as soon as you see Mima Ito back up, it's just quickly decreasing the chances of her winning the point.
Can't ever recall Mima lobbing down a top four Chinese player. Apart from Lu Xuan.
And Wang Manyu and Chun Meng.
Yeah.
But other than that, no, I'm just kidding.
Four, three.
Doesn't stand especially tall, but manages to get the racket high to stay on top of the bounce where she can. Keep the top spin down. Not in that one. Sinyin Shah up by one.
Ball. Oh.
I have to remind myself, this is still game three. I mean, they're dead even right now. Based on their recent history, Based on the score in the last game, it feels like we're deeper in this match and Mima Ito is in real trouble, but she's right here. The setup was so good, she really worked the angles in the early part of this point.
That was stunning. But before this point, Sun Yung Sha had lost 3 out of 3 going long serve into the back end of Mima. So after this serve, maybe we're going to see the tactic change from Sun.
What a save, Sun Yung Sha. I thought Mima Ito's shot down the line was enough for sure. To even get a racket on it. Let's see one more time. Backhand punch, and Sun Yung Sha plays it perfectly in the center of the racket.
Shallow spin it, which is harder for a shorter player to come over the top of. That's why we see Mima do the slap on the forehand quite a lot.
7-4.
Like a bullet, this push sails long. Trying to stay cool out here. The body's going to be hot, keeping the head cool. 12 out of the last 16 for Sha Sha.
Five, seven.
Body language of Mima Ito is still a bit unusual. Soft touch there. Earns herself that attack, goes deep to the corner. In slow-mo, it five, looks so seven. Simple. You have to remember, one, that's extreme slow motion. Two, she's playing against the best player in the world by a handful.
Five, eight.
And just a reminder of that on the step around here.
Spotted that one very early. And it has to be very early because of how fast that serve is from Ito.
5, I like it.
8.
Player knows. Both players know that quickly. Mima 8, smash, forehand 6. Flip, kill inside the table. A full swing there fearlessly from Mima.
Keeps getting within 2. And then Sun Yung Sha wins it to guarantee a 2-point cushion. Let's see if that happens again. Running out of time. It seems in this game. 3. Ito.
Strawberry 8, Central 7. Out here. Around the outside of the ball. The fact that she can play the strawberry to the wide forehand, short, long, and even the deep backhand, we're going to see a timeout here. Sha Sha. Interesting. That side spin. I mean, really, Sun Yung Sha, you saw at the Olympic Games the way she handled Mima Ito. It just felt like after game one, there was no chance. She was so well adapted. And on a rare occasion, Mima Ito bringing out side spin, it can be effective against a lot of players, but out here, I'm impressed that it's actually worked out in her favor.
This is the thing, right? You say Mima Ito misses that, you'd falter if you weren't really wise to the fact that it could really work.
Usually right. The fact that it did was impressive. It is the type of thing you might say, really, why now? It's funny. It's fun seeing Mima Ito in her corner with her stuff. It's just like a dreamland in a weird way.
Yeah, it looks like she just come from school.
Middle school?
Yeah.
Maybe elementary.
Well, I guess.
I like it.
Yeah.
I mean, I think it's fun, but it's just such an environment created by having everything was cute, even the ice pack. Mm. But there is a culture.
Not for sure.
Kawaii culture in Japan. So Sun Yung Sha still up by one here. Mima-chan shaking it out. Trying to stay loose and ready. Stay cool.
Eight,
as cool as can be. Comes in with the spin backhand. Again, spinnier than most of her shots, but less spinny than if she had used an inverted rubber for the same shot.
I don't know, that long serve tells me from Sun, I don't want Ito to give me any flair with the strawberry. So I'm going to deny it with the long serve. She shrugs it off even though it doesn't work out.
The construction of this point was very unusual. Right from the start, Mima Ito moves to the forehand side of the table. Her touch was outstanding, but once the open rally came, she never really came in with the hard shot, the specialties that she brings. So Sun Ying Sha up by one. What a response. Mima Ito gets the racket up quickly. The crowd could nearly even take back their celebration from Sha Sha's opening receive.
That is one of the most compact forearms I've ever seen. It clips the net.
Raises the hand. I mean, she doesn't move early. In the replay, you feel like she must have moved early. How could she possibly be in position for that shot? But racket at about shoulder height just moves it over to block the ball back. And here we are, 9 points apiece. What could be a pivotal game three. Big point to set up game point. Sha Sha uses her serve to convert.
Good receive, but a nice side swipe and guided flick there from Sha Sha.
I think that was the big surprise that really set her up in a good position and kept Mima Chan off the attack. Game point for world number one. And Sun Ying Sha by 2 points takes this third game for a 2-1 lead. She is one game away from moving on against the biggest rival to Team China, Mima Ito. But it is not over yet. Mima on her own in the corner. We'll figure things out. We'll get hydrated, we'll get ready and figure out what it's gonna take to cause some discomfort and trouble for world number one Sun Ying Sha. Coming up next, we've got the world's top chopper, the best defender in the game, and arguably the most aggressive, Ruan Filus of Germany. That classic style, we call that a chop, and we call him a chopper. He's the top of the world in that game, and Lin Win Ru, the silent assassin, has taken down big names quietly, including the greatest of all time, Ma Long, to get here, among others, and he will battle Ruan Filus in the match to follow.
Sun Ying Sha to serve, lob all.
So Mima Ito just going through the plan in her head again. It's Sun Ying Sha 2-1 up with the serves. Nice after motion there. The quicker you can move your racket away from the contact, the more difficult it is for the receiver to read. Just less clue there.
He's missed a few of the forehand counters, hasn't she, Ito? Yeah, it's tough to get over with a shorter player, right? But
she's done well. I think in many senses, it's the quality of the shot coming in. The body language of Mima Ito, again, whatever it can be to stretch out. Timeout now for Mima Ito. I think it's much needed. It's 0-3 down. They both have their timeouts at this moment. We'll have a chance to see what the corner looks like once again. There's something interesting about a battle so intense, and then coming back to your stuffed animals essentially on your backpack for a little bit of comfort. Just to be at home, right? Look at these guys. Egg yolk on the forehead. They've got nothing to worry about. I mean, that's the type of thing that just could relax you in theory. Like some fancy shoelaces there. High tech. So what is it that Mima Ito can do to get her game back in? I think she's been serving wonderfully from the backhand corner.
She has. And I don't know with Ito this match.
Just because Sun Yingxia's hit one or two of those long serves past her, she stopped doing it. But actually, percentage-wise, it still seemed like she was winning a fair share of points from the long, wide serve.
Right, it's tough to remind yourself. Again, this is what scar power is, really. Like, it just skews your memory. It's tough to keep track point for point of the exact percentages. Just certain points hurt more to lose. I think we all remember which point for Lin Shedong.
Yeah.
So out of the timeout, 1-1 here, Sun Yingxia, second serve.
Barely long with that punch there. Trying to get on her tippy toes to get over it.
And her reaction, that sort of puzzled look. Eh? It's just understandable because the amount of topspin coming in, she'd been fine to hit back for winners earlier. Could be that Shasha's turned it up a bit, or his pressure has changed, so is the demand. Ito's there, the shot is not. 1 point in the right direction for Mima Ito. Wow, was that only game one? Wow. Right, she had won. That's right, it was game one. She had served six serves from there. This time a little bit shorter. Deception, looks like mostly side spin. Whatever it was, it came back into the bottom of the net. Compact stroke. Remember, no timeouts left for Sun Yingxia either.
The only thing that I'm questioning right now about Shasha is her hunger after already beating Ito so many times. I know it's more than just Ito that she faces if she loses this, but can you see what I'm trying to say there?
Yeah, I do. That maybe, right, she's just a little bit relaxed in the moment.
Let. 5-4.
Mima Ito, you can imagine right now the thoughts there, but I think they're already out one ear. She's back and focused and ready. Perfect placement into the middle. It's a small middle with the racket very high and not so much wingspan on Mima Ito's side.
Zero sympathy shown, and it's one of the reasons why I'm so impressed that Ma Long never lost to Dima in the men's game.
Right, that's probably the most classic example. How many other people can say they've played 19 times internationally? Not too many parents.
Six.
Two points away. Still a chance to come back here in the fourth, Mima Ito. Outstanding placement. How does she drop it that short and wide?
That is almost miraculous. Speaking of that, that's a Dima kind of touch, the backhand from the forehand. But yeah, I think the short pips help her get it so short there, actually.
Were you imagining the Timo versus Chen Wei Xing?
Remember,
that's what that looked like.
The one where Chen Wei Xing claps after the point.
That's right, that's the one. Incredible touch play in near the net. 1 point game, Mima Chan's second serve. I thought Mima did well to recover after that wide backhand, but Shasha never really let go of the point.
Constantly changing the trajectory there, direct into backhand. Spinnier one, and then a kind of slower, more arcy one.
It's tough. You can feel the idea that Mima Chan has to just sort of brush, add a little bit of side spin, but not easy to do from that position with Shasha where she hits it. Incredible point. She does everything, Mima Ito, and Shasha answers until finally. finally, a slap back. How many times did she have to handle heat and turn it up?
That one there, she did better at. Oh, yeah. Nice little drop shot. And then that.
So much work for 1 point. Okay. To me, that's a face that's ready to do it again if she has to. Wouldn't hope for it. I mean, that could have won 3 points.
Six. Hey.
That's genius, isn't it? And Sasha. Long pass to middle. Such an aggressive serve.
Fairly gutsy, too. Has to keep it well disguised there to cause the trouble so that Mima can't turn. Oh, surprise. Mima thought she had her pinned and the ball was coming back to the backhand corner. Sasha, very clever under pressure.
Let's see. Spinny one. Oh, the seatbelt shot.
Who would have thought? I mean, the most obvious place to go is cross court in that moment. Mima thought she had her opponent handcuffed. Sasha, 2 points away from a victory. Make that one. And she's got the serves on her side to do it. The crowd, look at how they feel right now. They weren't mimicky, like they were all just feeling that in that moment, shaking their fists to say, come on, we got this. There's a fly. I feel like we're playing charades. A fly, it's on the table, it's a fly. It's got wings, something with wings.
No,
it's a jackal. Jackal? It's a jackal. Definitely a jackal. Okay.
10-6.
The winged friend has been gently removed, and Sasha with 4 match points. Ooh, the dribbler staying alive. BG's out here. Mima Ito saves 1 match point. To get up again, she had to squat and then come right back up. This one, no Miyu Kihata. That's okay, Marlin says. No problem. You did everything right. Can't control that. Ah, handling it herself this time around.
Looked like Marlin looked up at the big screen there because he knew that the cameraman was going to capture his reaction to that point.
We've definitely enjoyed watching the facial expressions. 3 match points left for the world number one. And there it is. Sasha once again defeats the greatest threat to Team China. Mima Ito will be looking for answers and will go back to the Mima cave to study and find some new tricks. But a 22-year-old on a 22-year-old out here, it is Swinging Sha, world number one, who comes out on top, victorious, and a high five in the corner. She's got a spot in the semifinals after a dominated game number one by Mima Ito, quickly turned around and never let go of the steering wheel after that. 9-7 to follow that 11-6 victory. Sasha is going to make the crowd quite happy and keep the stadium full. Just in case you were curious how they looked side by side, outscored by 6, Mima Ito and Sunying Sha. Service game, quite interesting, really. I'd say the proportions there, nothing too crazy. Longest point streak, Mima had 6 in a row. But other than that, everything's similar. Let's hear from Sasha.
Congratulations, Sasha. 恭喜你，莎莎拿下比赛。 This is first encounter with Ito Mima after the Tokyo Olympics. What was your secret to winning this match?
这是你和伊藤美诚在东京奥运会后的首次交手。你认为赢得这场比赛的关键是什么？其实我觉得今天整场比赛，其实我们俩也是都发挥出了最好的水平吧。其实，在比赛的过程中也有很多精彩的回合，包括 高质量的对抗吧，其实也是跟伊藤也是时隔了将近有一年半的时间没有交手过。其实我觉得他在一年半多也是进步了很多吧。其实自己第一局也是上来很久没打，确实感觉节奏啊，包括准备的，还是跟自己想象中会有一些偏差吧。但我觉得在第二局慢慢一直到最后，还是调整到自己舒服的感觉去比赛。
Today, both Ito and I thought all of
both of us performed our best. In a match, we also presented many excellent rallies like the high quality encounters. It has been 1.5 years ever since I had a match with Ito. She has made a lot of progress. In the first game, because I haven't fought against her for a long time, I didn't control my tempo. Things were not the same as I imagined before. But in game two, I made adjustments and I won the game.
You will be facing Chen Meng in the next round. How are you going to prepare for it? 下一轮你将对阵陈梦，为此你会做何准备呢？
我觉得其实还是全力以赴去拼梦姐吧。其实相对来说还是自己输的多一些嘛，所以我觉得面对半决赛的比赛，还是希望自己能够享受比赛吧，然后在赛场中去专注每一分。
I'd like to try my best to fight against Chen Meng because in our encounters I lost more. So tomorrow in the semifinals I'd like to enjoy the game and be more focused on the competition.
Congratulations to you again, Xia Xia. 谢谢，再次把掌声给到我们这场比赛的赢家孙颖尚。
One day I will say I did it. Sun Yingxia, the quote that you've seen around the stadium.Well, she's done it here today to get through Mima Ito 3-1. Really an outstanding encounter. After 1.5 years of not playing, Sun Yingxia will battle Chen Meng in the semifinals tomorrow. There is nobody but Team China, and it is the best in the world, except for Wang Manyu, who is beaten by Chen Xingtong. So, a surprise semifinalist will battle against Wang Yidi, but the next match is the one the world has been waiting for. Can a chopper take down...The silent assassin Ruin Filus versus Lin Yun Ru. That match coming up right after this. This is it, the Infinity Arena. The action has been going down here and has been turned up to the next level today. The matches we have witnessed have been an absolute privilege from the start of this session. Chen Meng and Hina Hayata, if you missed it live, when this next one finishes, go over to WTT's YouTube channel and check it out because it was amazing. Fan Zhendong and Lin Zhendong as well. Man, have we been treated to some world-class table tennis in Sun Yingxia and Mima Ito, but this next one is the one the world has been waiting for. Ruin Filus of Germany, top chopper versus Lin Win Ru.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the world number 33 from Germany, Ruben Filus.
接下来，让我们一起欢迎世界排名第十，来自中华台北的李明儒。
Let's welcome the world number 10 from Chinese Taipei, 李明儒。
So here he is, the silent assassin. For the last handful of years, maybe even more than 5 years now, he's been one of the greatest threats to Team China, and he's beaten the greatest of all time for his fourth time here. And it was at a WTT Champions. Interestingly enough, the head-to-head for world number 10, Lin Win Ru, with Ruin Filus, the world number 33, is 0-2. Ruin Filus came back not too long ago from down 0-3 to win four straight games and take the match. He's dangerous with his attacking game as well as his chop. This will be a best of five, so the first player to win three games wins the match. Games played to 11 points, must win by two. Coach Iseki, as he was known in Japan, Coach Wei, his Chinese name. And here our umpire, Zhu Ling, will be taking care of the coin toss to determine where the players stand and who serves. We've got the smoothest, arguably the smoothest in the game, in Lin Win Ru.
Toss, please.
And the most unpredictable in the game, with the world's top chopper, Ruin Filus. What do the fans think? 82% expect Lin Win Ru to win this match, despite the fact that he's 0-2. This always makes me curious. Is it what they want or what they believe will happen?
Toss, please. Black or red? Black for you, red for you. Red, you win the toss. Receive.
Receive, he says. So Ruin Filus loses the coin toss but gets the first serve. I'm your commentator, Adam Bobro, with me, friend and fellow table tennis enthusiast, Fraser Riley. Fraser, this should be good.
Hello, my brother, using different rubbers once more. An amazing match. Yeah, interesting head-to-head. And it's not even as though he played Lin Win Ru when he was a young junior. Played him twice in the last two seasons and won both.
And a look at how he's done against some of his other opponents here, who he had to knock out in the round of 32, Croatia's Andrej Gacina, 3-2. And then 3-1 to eliminate the world number 5, the thrill from Brazil, Hugo Calderano. I mean, this right now has been a bit of a Cinderella story for Ruin Filus, but the story, well, still being written. We shall see. 21 years old on the other side, the world number 10. Lin Win Ru has played the Chinese Super League, has a 70% career win record, and just shut down the King of Africa, Quadri Aruna. Not so many have been able to do that. Well, I should say many have fallen at the hands of Quadri Aruna. Then after that, Ma Long 3-1, so only one game dropped, despite the fact that he's played two incredible forehands, two very different styles. But if styles could get any more different, they would be Ruin Filus. So $35,000 in prize money for the champion, $800,000 across the two events, men's and women's singles. And 1,000 points in world rankings. We're looking at a bronze medalist in mixed doubles from the Olympic Games. We're looking at nearly a bronze medalist in singles from the Olympic Games, but a compatriot of this man here, that's Dmitry Ovcharov, saved match points and took that bronze medal. So, Ruin Filus here, 2-0. What's going to be different today? Who knows? He looked like he's played through injury, but it hasn't stopped him yet. Ruin Filus, again, he's a traditional chopper only in the sense that he has long pips on the backhand side. That means they're more defensive, so we can't have an easy time
Filus
attacking with them.
Filus versus Lin. First game, Filus to serve, love all.
He's going to start with the serve with the spinny side. good start here on the defense, Ruin Filus.
Can't help Adam but look back at that WTT contender Almaty final. Amazing.
Hey.
Just for some context, this is the last time they played, by the way. Filus was 3-0 down. It was one of the best comebacks and one of the rarest types of comebacks I've ever seen. And then we will be hungry for revenge.
Bit of a break off the top of the net. Now, I said that with the long pips, it's tough to be aggressive. That said, Ruin Filus more aggressive than most inside the table. You'll watch him twiddle that racket in his hand, turn it around 180 degrees so that he can attack with the black spinny side. But service game, Lin-Min Ru doing a good bottle challenge serve long to the backhand. Punishing Ruin Filus, quickly sending him back to that corner, not allowing him to creep in.
Two, three.
From the silent assassin, who just get a bit vocal, so not fully silent.
Yeah, this has come over the recent years, but still a fitting name.
Ooh. Two, three.
I want to see a ball come off the camera and back into play, just saying. It is so tough to lift something
three,
that heavy
four.
And short. Way out in front. Watch where this ball comes down. Ruin Filus bounces. I mean, the table's still an obstacle for Lin-Min Ru on that ball.
For sure. Couldn't agree more. This clash here of styles is, I think, going to be reflective of the fact that Lin-Min Ru has developed his lower body. It's going to be helpful against Filus. You've got to lift all that backspin.
Three, four.
Caught him in the middle, finally, what a point. Real testing of the lungs there and the footwork, Ruin Filus. I couldn't believe he made the shot from under the table with the long pips.
Insane.
Not only that, but Lin-Min Ru was able to read it perfectly. Tricky, tricky. Burned. Comes in with topspin and it's just too familiar. We saw more power against Ma Long than we've seen from Lin-Min Ru. For me, he's always been smooth, but the power that we see just seemed to be a new Lin-Min Ru. But when the top spin comes in, he gets a little bit more comfortable to really turn up the pace.
Straight arm right over the top of that one. Oh, yeah.
How quickly he comes back up, too. The legs stronger than they used to be. He's bulking up, the 21-year-old Lin-Min Ru.
Now, Filus obviously won't chop with the forehand side. He'll either fish or counter, sometimes lob as well. He's an incredible lobber of the ball, Filus.
Yeah,
as well.
We've seen him play some outstanding high balls. A lot of different answers, but yeah, we don't see him chop on the forehand. It's quite rare, at least not that I can recall anyway. Some people, it's just like it's against their religion out here. I mean, Jonis would not do it.
Jonis was the chopper that beat Lin-Min Ru at the 2019 World Championships.
Whoa. So in terms of choppers, I think there's something to prove here. Lin-Min Ru, again, 0-2 against this top chopper. There's the lob. Does not come down. Confidence as Lin-Min Ru moves into the table again. Whenever he sees topspin on it, he's going to be that much more comfortable.
Moves in
to follow. And after that wide angle, just earns himself a little bit higher chop to crush.
9-5.
Tough time right now. Zrun Filus gives up a serve.
Unreturnable, but not in the right way. I was going to say, Filus has been making it hard for Lin Wenmu to play his signature flick.
And just constantly moving it on the table. Like the bottle challenge serve, it's a similar rotation. That pendulum serve long into the middle of the table. 7 of the last 8 points, and it's 5 game points for Lin Wenmu. Only needs the 11, one in five. Control here to make game a statement. He started strong in the past, though. So, game one is done. That can't be changed. They're both coming back, fighting for game two in this best of five. A lot on the line here. Germany's Ruin Filus, the Chinese Taipei team's Lin Wenmu. A look at the world rankings as of week 15 in 2023. Lin Wenmu just hanging on to the world top 10, but after beating Ma Long and earning himself a decent draw, considering that Ruin Filus has beaten Hugo Calderano, although style matchup-wise, not so many are 2-0 against Lin Wenmu. Look who else is in the top 10. Truls Morgaard eliminated by Alexi Lebrun. Dong Cho, wow, I mean, just players keep getting dropped. It was Lin Shedong who knocked out Dong Cho. Lin Gaoyuan not here. And then the top four, 3-4, Tomokazu Harimoto and Ma Long knocked out. Lim Jong-hoon knocking out Harimoto, and Lin Wenmu knocking out Ma Long.
Second game, Lin to serve, love all.
In case your favorite player is Hugo Calderano, Truls Morgaard, Tomokazu Harimoto, or Ma Long, we've got the Champions Macau coming up just next week. So you'll be seeing your favorites again real soon, but still a handful of your favorites left right now. This one service game love is so strong.
It's the same service motion, and it's not until he's already served it that you know that he's going to try and do the bottle challenge or the long fast one elsewhere on the table.
This is it. All you need is two different serves that look the same. Service percentage 2/3 for Lin Wenmu, and only a quarter for Ruin Filus. As soon as the topspin comes in, I mean, Ruin Filus, it's tough. You can recognize that it's happening. He doesn't get as much spin variation as a short pitch chopper, Ruin Filus, but his attack is what was winning him everything yesterday. So this is right for me. Ruin Filus, while he's only won 4 of the last 16, he needs to try and take some attacks. Even if it's with the long pips inside the table, put some pressure on early, but stay close. Just incredible. It's the legs now that he can get back up. It's a lot of work for the attacker playing a chopper. Again, the amount of strength it takes to keep these attacks out of the net, crazy.
Filus is trying his best to chop from even the forehand side now, because he knows that the fist that he does is a ball that Lin Wenmu is more accustomed to.
Did he give a chop from his forehand?
Yeah. Not wide forehand, though.
Using the forehand side of the racket?
No, the backhand side.
Okay.
Yeah. Love.
It's like I couldn't recall seeing it.
No. You would be right in assuming that.
So 8 of the last 8. Lin Wenmu. First human moment in quite some time from Lin Wenmu. So Ruin Filus on the scoreboard. You could see how he was looking to get in for the attack, Filus.
I think it confused Lin a little bit there. Like Filus was going for an exhibition style point. Just lofted it up.
Yeah, he was caught at the back of the table. Didn't want to lose his hand over a point. This is it. Serves with the long pips, attacks with the forehand rubber on the follow-up. Not as much spin on it. Still not a bad receive. If I were Ruin Filus, I think I'd do everything I can to get the attack. Good try. I think that's fair. It was tough early on, because you have to remember, one side of his racket is meant for defense, the red side. So he'll have to twiddle, but it's not always going to be in the right position. Lin-Min Ru is going to constantly be playing to the long pip side where he can. For example, fast and long to the backhand, service game strong.
7-2.
And what can you do against it? Because it's a guessing game, and you don't want to be too far from the table in case he does serve long, because then he's going to dink it short.
He's got the good touch.
I just feel like, Adam, we're going to have to see something so out of the ordinary here from Filus.
My thinking is, whatever he has to do to attack, if that means serve pendulum, put it on your forehand, serve with the inverted. And a tomahawk serve with a ripping backhand.
3-8.
I think this is a combination, right? It's two unusual things. He immediately twiddles before the ball's contacted because he expects it to his backhand. Twice. This is a player who recognizes that he's got his pips cornered. Lin-Win Ru blade there. We see, oh, cool shot. The personalized model, nice. Not everybody has their own blade. That's a nice statement that you've achieved something in this sport. At 21 years old, Lin-Win Ru with a personal blade.
It's an expensive blade to just get a signature of and end up putting on the shelf, but I mean, if it's Lin-Win Ru's signature you're after, why not?
Yeah, and if you can afford it, you might as well. But yeah, as we were saying before, Ruin Filus is basically going to try to set up a mirage, make it look like his pips are somewhere, and then quickly have the inverted there and attack. He knows the chase is for his red side. Did you see his hand? I was watching Ruin Filus' hand before this point started, and he was fiddling the racket, just getting ready to twiddle in case. 6 game points for Lin-Win Ru. Takes his chances,
11-4.
But 11-4, Lin-Win Ru comes to the table with an incredible plan and tactically is making it a very tough day for Ruin Filus here at work.
Wouldn't surprise me to see some sky lobs in this game 3 coming up, because he's trying everything out here. Still one-way traffic.
So given some confidence from Coach Wei in the corner, and also recent history after only allowing 9 points total between 2 games.
The third game, Filus to serve, love all.
Lin-Win Ru will stay focused and do everything he can to make sure that Ruin Filus can only attack from very uncomfortable positions, if at all. And trying to use the long pips more aggressively here instead of chopping to play a block awkwardly. Again, just looking for answers. I think he's doing the right thing to just keep trying new things.
2-love.
I like the serve of Filus. Kind of stalls and stares into the eyes of his opponent before he does it. Lin-Win Ru unfazed at the moment. Look at that.
75% exactly from Lin-Win Ru on the service game, and just under 30 converted. Just to make that more clear for you, when Lin-Win Ru is serving 75% of the time before this point, he wins. When Ruin Filus is serving not even 30% of the points, he wins.
all.
So those stats will quickly change after 2 points here for Muin Filus. Again, a long pips chopper can still vary the spin, but not as much as a short pips chopper. You can see him getting ready for that third ball attack.
Two.
From behind the table, he's still dangerous. Take a look there. Top and side spin. And then waiting for the third ball attack.
Three.
Outstanding handcuffs here. Lin Yunru gets Muin Filus to stay off the aggressive attack. He's done his job.
I feel like one of the main advantages Filus actually has right now is history, having come back on the brink of defeat last time against Lin Yunru.
Got it. A lot of history jokes in there that could be fun, but I completely agree. 2-0, Muin Filus. But in a dangerous position now, down 0-2 in a best of five.
Three.
Liang Jingquan awaits the winner of this match, and without at all underlooking Muin Filus, I think he would have rather have played the German defender.
The touch, the soft
three,
hands here.
Five.
Muin Ru, and now we're going to have a timeout from Muin Filus. Combinations of play, that wide opening attack, and the touch just the other way.
Well, he's seen the lighter side of the situation here, Filus. We spoke about defenders that have their own blade, and I think he's using the juicy hook there. He deserves his own blade. He's the best defender in the world. He's throwing his water bottle on the floor there. Not as bad
three,
as lobbing your racket
five.
And nearly hitting a cameraman like we saw at the smash. He's a nice guy, Muin Filus. But he's not afraid to show when he's a bit miffed.
Four, five.
That backhand,
five,
such a swing.
Oh.
It's funny, I can only think of Krianga's backhand, and even still, this might be an even bigger motion. Topspin comes in, that twiddle and the rip. And I love how as soon as he finishes, he comes around and twiddles the rubber back to his forehand side, the spinny black rubber. Ah, pushed with the inverted rubber on that one.
Five, six.
It's one other way to twiddle. I think this is also one other way to add spin variation to your game.
Great, great run of points here after the timeout from Muin Filus.
He's been down. As you mentioned, 0-3 before, and in a best of five, a 0-2 comeback would seem even more recoverable. Although the score line from Lin Yunru so convincing in these first two.
One thing I like about Filus, as well as his amazingly entertaining style, is the fact that he will draw this out. He'll make this as long as he can and try every little thing he can to throw him off.
Six, seven.
Well, feel for him there, all jokes aside.
There it is, it's what you wanted, but it doesn't come down. He's wondering
eight,
from that position It's not easy. Actually, lobbing to a lefty generally can be quite uncomfortable. The main reason is you might want to keep it to an uncomfortable place for them, like the backhand side of the table, where a righty would be the opposite side. Perfectly calibrated, just closes the racket on top of the spin. A string of points recently, that's a well-rounded cap from Coach Wei. Was going to say, though, that Lin Wenru doing an excellent job there to handle a deep spinny ball. Excellent angle here for Ruin Filus.
7-9.
Still here. I'm just happy for Phyllis about how many
fans
to play. He has earned
time out.
Being here in the most populous table tennis nation and entertaining the world.
So a timeout now for Lin Wenru after that edge ball. So both players have called their timeouts now. Lin Wenru still up by two. Knows what it's like to have Ruin Filus come back and turn things around.
7-9.
Speaking of turn things around, keep an eye on that racket. He played a relatively aggressive shot with those pits, relatively dead, and still Lin Wenru focused, spins it back, and has earned himself three match points to earn a semifinal place. And he does it. Lin Wenru moves on through to the final four. Liang Jingquan will be his date in the next round. The final four men here. The silent assassin quietly takes down the Cinderella story. Germany's Ruin Filus, 5-4-7. Only 16 points, just more than 5 points average per game. Wow. I mean, more than double the points of his opponent. Lin Wenru stayed in control, used the timeout wisely. His tactics were clear from the start. And with legs behind him, the muscle he's built up over the years has paid off to give him the strength, stability, and recovery that he needed to make sure that for the first time in his career, he gets the best of Ruin Filus. So we'll look here at what we have to look forward to. Interesting. There could be a final with no Chinese players in it, but it would take some big upsets. Lim Jong-hoon will be battling against the world number one Fang Zhendong, and on the other side it'll be the Chinese Taipei team's silent assassin Lin Wenru versus Liang Jingquan. Let's hear from Lin Wenru now.
Congratulations, Wenru. This is your third encounter with Ruben and your first win against him. What makes this match different from the previous ones? 恭喜你，Wenru。
这是你第三次与Ruben交手，也是第一次打败他。这场比赛与之前的比赛有何不同呢？自己可能就前面也打过两次，然后也大概知道他的一些球路，然后在赛前的准备自己也做得比较好，然后所以很开心可以赢下比赛。你先过去。
I have two matches before with Ruben, and I know his play style. Before the match, I made a very good preparation, so I was very happy to win the game.
Now, into the semifinals, you will be up against Liang Jingquan, who's in excellent form in this whole week. How are you going to prepare for the clash tomorrow? 现在你也进入了半决赛，你的下一个对手是这一整周状态都很好的梁靖昆，那你将如何准备下一场呢？
就对手还是非常强，然后就希望自己还是可以一场一场去打，好好打。
My opponent is very strong. I hope I can try my best to fight to win each game.
Thank you. Congratulations again. 让我们再次恭喜林昀儒获得本场比赛的胜利。
So Lin Winru well prepared. We'll look forward to this upcoming match. It's interesting. I had a chance to chat with him and he said, well, I think I'll do it in Chinese, this interview, because we're in China. I can just sort of entertain the crowd a little bit with it. But his English is solid, although he was quite nervous after his victory against Ma Long. But here today, well prepared. The only player with a bagel for his opponent. Lin Winru, clean sweep after Chun Meng narrowly beat Hina Hayata in an epic battle.Fang Zhendong and Lin Shidong with one of the hardest hitting, most impressive matches I've ever seen. But Fang Zhendong moved on in the world number one, Sun Ying Sha, 3-1 over Japan's Mima Chan, Mima Ito, who came out blazing and playing some world-class table tennis. So all these stars you'll have a chance to look forward to. Day six, tomorrow, Wang Yidi will battle against Chun Xing Tong, who beat Wang Man Yu, pulling off the upset. Lin Winru will be back.The Silent Assassin will play Big Fatty Liang Jingquan. Then Sun Ying Xia will battle Chun Meng, formerly the top two in the world, a rematch of the Olympic final. You saw the last one on screen. We can't wait to have you right back here tomorrow for the WTT Champion Xinjiang 2023. On behalf of Fraser Riley and myself, Adam Bobrow, Wan An, good night, and Ming Tian Jian, see you tomorrow.